Gregorio!
Antonio!
Hey, yo, what's up out there?
Ice Cube! How you guys doing?
That is not good.
Get ready to experience the thrill of a lifetime.
If you somehow find this offensive,
just don't listen. But my guess is you'll be sticking around.
Let's do this.
It's going down, Jack.
Hey, it's Larry King welcoming you to the Opie and Anthony Show right here on Sirius XM's satellite radio.
Oh, this is good radio right here.
Y'all are cooler than shit.
It starts funny and then gets very uncomfortable.
One of the most popular radio shows in the world.
Radio journalism at its best.
Hello, kids. It's the Opie and Anthony Show. They swear and they're vulgar and they talk about awful, awful things. That's what you like, isn't it?
Very flavorful.
Yay.
That's what you like, isn't it?
Please welcome Opie. The show is twisted, I'm telling you. We're enjoying this shit.
That's what you like, isn't it?
Anthony.
I want dick prizes. Oh, I love when girls go through that. I'm here for you, ladies. Remember that.
That's what you like, isn't it?
And Jim Norton.
If a pussy could talk, it would say, die.
That's what you like, isn't it?
Everything you are about to hear is real.
My nipples are kind of hard.
Good morning. Welcome aboard.
But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
Morning, everybody.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Oh, my God.
Look at that. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Whoa, 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 whoa. How's everybody?
Sleepy, I guess.
Yeah.
Sleepy?
A little bit. A little bit.
That whole,
Man, coming in from the beach house is rough.
Oh, that's right. That's a long drive.
Rough.
You came in again last night?
Oh, yeah. It's worth it. It's worth it to dig another hole for my son. Oh, my God.
Holes on the beach.
Holes on the beach. I was just telling Anthony, like, kids just don't understand anything.
Nah.
Kids are stupid.
Kids are silly.
I don't think my kid is stupid, but he's still a kid, so he is stupid. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And one day, about 5 days ago, I decided a nice little family activity, a nice father-son activity, would be to dig a nice big beach hole in the sand.
Ooh.
You remember doing that as a kid, right, Anthony?
I certainly do. They're very dangerous, though.
So we had shitty little fucking plastic shovels,
yeah.
But I got it done. But then I discovered the real fucking shovel in the garage.
Oh, man.
So I dug a hole that was deeper than him.
You're going out there with power tools.
Yeah. But I dug an impressive hole. I'm like, if you're going to fucking dig a hole, let's do this shit.
Mm-hmm.
And he helps a little bit by pushing all the sand back in the hole as I'm trying to dig the hole, which is its own problem because I have to yell at him, go, it's not ready yet. The hole's not ready yet.
When is the hole ready?
No, that's a very good question.
When is
that's
it ready?
A great question. When you hit water, everyone knows that.
Oh, okay.
You want to dig a hole on the beach until you hit water.
Right.
That is the answer, Anthony Cunha.
Then you get like, oh, that's kind of cool. Water's in the hole.
Yeah, water's in the hole.
How's that happen?
And you do it close to the shoreline because then you have to play that game of like, let's try to protect our hole.
Oh, because now the waves start coming in?
Yeah, like a 15-year-old girl just trying to protect her hole.
Her hole. So you got to build up a little wall around the edges?
See, you know this shit.
Yeah, yeah.
So now we're protecting the hole from the waves coming in. And
oh,
I look at the tide charts. I'm a good dad.
Oh, man.
So I'm like, all right, the tide's coming in at 6:30. So if I start digging the hole around 4:30, then we hang out a little bit. Yeah. And then, you know, the water's going to start coming in.
That's when the battle starts.
We have a breach
in the wall, and you gotta patch it up.
And that's fun for a while. And then, of course, you know, nature always wins, and you have to give up on the hole.
Yes.
And it was a fine activity, father-son activity.
Time and tide wait for no man, apparently.
That was 5 days ago.
Yeah.
I dug my fifth hole yesterday.
Oh,
Jeez. Because kids don't understand.
Oh, do it again.
He just assumes I'm Superman and can dig this massive hole every day. My back is so fucking sore right now.
He just hunched over digging holes.
Every day. Every day it's become the thing that we have to dig the hole.
I like this and then, we.
Oh, yeah.
Because he just watches.
No, he walks around the edge and knocks fucking sand in the hole. It drives me insane. Every day.
How deep?
Yesterday was easily 4 feet.
Holy jeez.
Easily.
And you get into the hole?
Yes.
That's very dangerous.
I think you meant like a little fucking, like a pan-sized hole.
No, that's what I'm talking about. Matter of fact, yesterday I'm a little tired from digging the four prior holes, so I try to cheat a little bit, and I try to make a small hole. He goes, this hole isn't as big as yesterday.
Found a friend, Harry. I can hold my breath for a long time.
Right. If you don't believe me.
Yeah.
I wish I could post these pictures, but my kid is a civilian. But look.
You could blur.
Look, that's how big the hole is.
Dude, that's like fucking, that's major excavation going on.
Yes. Yes. And the beauty, though, if you do it right, you don't have to put any sand back in the hole. The ocean takes care of that shit.
Oh.
And within a few hours, there's no sign there was ever a hole there.
Isn't it amazing?
Look. That's how big the hole is.
That's a giant hole.
And I'm 5 days in, and I don't know how to tell them. I got to stop. I can't be digging these huge holes every day.
Jesus.
Right.
Isn't that amazing how the fucking ocean will just take care of that shit?
It's completely take care of it. Like, smooth, no indentation, like there was sort of a hole there. It's unbelievable, actually.
I laugh when people go, we got to save the planet. We got to do it.
Right.
If we were gone for fucking any period of time, the Earth would just reclaim everything.
One generation. I think. Hold on. Tom makes an incredibly good point here. Tom in Brooklyn, go ahead.
Hey, good morning, guys. You got some nerve calling the kids stupid. You're digging five holes?
Right. I know I'm the stupid one. Yeah. You're absolutely right. But I don't know how to reason with my kid. He doesn't get it.
There is no reasoning. Listen, I've had a few kids. You just go to something different.
You just stop, right?
Yeah, you just stop. You know, there's nothing wrong with a kid crying. There's nothing wrong with a kid getting his feelings hurt. And then go into something else. I'll learn.
All right, I'm going to try that today, Tom, because I don't think I can dig a sixth hole. I don't think I can do it. Look, I got fucking blisters on my hand.
I'm like a
working man.
Well,
all right,
good
brother.
Luck to you.
All right, thanks, Tom. You're right. I'm stupid, not my kid. I'm the one digging the fucking holes. So that was my afternoon.
Digging holes on the beach.
Digging holes.
Yeah, that's what you got to do.
After the big meeting with Scott Greenstein yesterday.
Oh, the big meeting. Yes. That was fun, wasn't it?
I drove, I live in Manhattan, so, I mean, my commute's 10 minutes, but when I drive about an hour and a half, hour and 45 minutes, it gives you a lot of time to think. These are my thoughts.
Oh.
This business has passed us by.
Oh, shit.
That's my thought today.
In what way?
It's just a world that we don't belong in anymore.
Wow.
And it's unfortunate. And it's not because we're getting older or any of that shit. It's that this business has become so fucking wimpy.
Yeah.
So fucking wimpy.
I gotta agree with you.
There's no edge left. I mean, we're holding on to the little edge we got, but our knives...
That's because we're on satellite, too.
Our knives are a bit dull right now.
Oh,
they used to be really fucking sharp. And I was thinking that they're making all the same mistakes as regular radio. Like, satellite radio had such a huge lead on everything.
That is true.
And they're doing the exact same stuff that made us sick of regular radio.
Yeah.
They don't understand what we do. The boss doesn't even know which guy's in trouble, what his name is.
I was like, wow.
I sat in that meeting yesterday. I'm like, why are we even wasting time in this fucking office? And then Blatter's called me all night last night. I didn't even answer the phone because I'm like, I know you have nothing.
He gave me he left a message on my phone.
But I know he has nothing really of importance to say to me.
Yeah.
basically went down the hall after the show yesterday to fight for our pal Troy Kwan. We're all really good friends with Troy Kwan. We hang out with him socially. We think he has been great for the radio show. He does great production. He's never said no to us. He comes in here and gives us really good radio. We like that he goes over the top.
Of course. That's his whole thing.
We've encouraged him to go over the top because it gets people talking. So, you know, between us encouraging him and him having that type of personality to begin with, we loved it.
Yes.
Absolutely loved it. Also knowing that he didn't mean pretty much anything he has said on this fucking show. So he's still not fired, but he's not back from suspension.
Mm-hmm.
There's some weird tug of war going on with people upstairs that we've never met. Never met.
You never get an answer as to who is responsible for doing anything.
Right.
Like, okay, why don't we sit face to face with the person
right.
that wants to fire him? There is no person.
They couldn't give us a name.
No.
They couldn't
There's
give
no
us a name.
Name. There's no entity. It's this vague
right.
consortium of beings that run things.
Well, some of the highlights of the meeting, I think it's worth talking about because I'll say it again. People out there, they deal with this shit at their jobs.
Right.
So we got a major problem with Troy Kwan, right? We don't think there's any problem whatsoever. And they think it's a major problem for whatever reason.
Yeah.
And so we sit down, me, Jimmy, and Ant, and the first thing Scott Greenstein says is, all right, let's get into the... How did he say it? How did he say his name wrong?
He said,
Sam Roberts.
We gotta take care of this Tony situation.
This Tony situation.
And I was like, ha, ha.
He doesn't even know the guy's name.
It's not the guy's name.
And I don't think he really does know the guy's name. I don't think that was a brain fart.
It was so indicative of the whole thing.
So we looked at him like, his name's Troy.
Yeah.
Not Tony. And then we're arguing the case like, you know, I mean, there were threats. Troy made threats against Mark Zito.
Yeah.
But he didn't mean any of the fucking threats. And it was very obvious to everybody.
Yeah.
But they're taking it very seriously upstairs.
We're so sorry, Cassie. Remember the movie Carrie, where the principal was apologizing for the girls throwing the tampons at her and kept getting her name wrong? We're so sorry, Cassie.
Right. My name's Carrie.
Right. So we decided to bring out some case law.
We were quoting case law.
We certainly were. We quoted the Bubba situation with me.
Yes.
We quoted the Artie Lang situation.
Uh-huh.
The situation with me was Bubba said he wanted to beat the shit out of me. And what was concerning was he also told the listeners to beat the shit out of me.
Yeah, if they see you, you know, just beat the shit out of you.
And that's very similar to the Troy Kwan Marzito thing because it's one employee threatening another employee. It's pretty much the exact situation.
Yeah,
except
yeah.
in the Bubba situation, he decided to go one step higher and have the listeners also try to beat the shit out of me.
Yeah.
And Scott goes, this has to be said. It has to be said today. I want it on the record. I want it out there. He goes, that's just two on-air guys fighting.
Like, yeah, what do you think?
But that's what happened
with
Troy and Mark Zito.
That's exactly what happened.
Right.
Yeah.
And in the end, I was a little concerned because he got the listeners involved, but I didn't make a big fucking deal about it because, you know, if you're going to dish it out, you got to take it.
Yeah.
And I know how this shit works. And I knew in the end, no one was going to beat the fuck out of me. I know Bubba the Love Sponge wasn't going to fucking come up here.
Right.
And beat me up.
Yeah.
Which goes back to the Troy thing. Everyone, when we left the studio that day, we knew he didn't mean any of that shit and everything would be fine.
There was no more danger in this place after that argument than there was before. Like, nothing was going to happen.
Nothing.
Let's be real here.
So then Jimmy brings up the Artie Lang situation. I don't know the exact facts of the Artie Lang situation, but he had a problem with somebody on the Stern show
who works
for the company.
I don't even know if the guy works for the company or works for Artie. But Artie kind of lunged at him, or threw
Kenny
something
knows.
At him.
Oh, Kenny.
It was Teddy, Artie's assistant at the time.
Okay. What exactly happened? He did lunge for him, or
does he work for Sirius?
Did he
work for Sirius?
Oh, okay.
So he worked for Sirius.
And he still does, as far as I know.
And he still does.
Okay.
Yeah. And Artie...
Yeah, he went for him. He, you know, Artie might have been high at the moment. This is back 2009.
Yeah, and they got into an argument, and Artie said, "I'll kick your ass," and lunged at him, and guys had to intercede and hold him back.
And the point, you know, if honestly, you know, because obviously Artie's gone, he doesn't work anymore. So I'm like, well, how is that different? And and Scott said, well, he's like, ah, that's different. And he got a little, and it's like, you can't, I'm not going to yell at him. So I'm like, well, with all due respect, how is that different? Like, logically, how is that different than this situation other than this one is milder?
He said the Troy thing is worse. And we're like, how is it worse than a guy actually lunging after a fellow employee? Yeah. I'm like, how is it worse? And once again, everyone understood in that environment, the Howard Stern environment, the Opie and Anthony environment, some shit is going to go down. But in the end, nothing really bad ever happens, and everyone moves on. I'm sure by the next day, everything was cool with Artie and that guy.
I think in that moment, Howard even jumped in and said, look, no, like, he actually took it back to, like, no, you can't touch somebody. Like, he made a thing out of, like, you can't touch another person in you know what I mean? He did something about, like, you know, he actually thought that was almost too far because he physically went for him. It wasn't even just yelling. It was a physical thing.
But Scott said what Troy did was worse than that. So
I don't...
I'm trying to remember some of the other highlights.
Yeah. Low lights.
And then there was just, like, you know, we absolutely won the debate in that office yesterday, us three, against Scott. To the point, Scott just started yelling. He went with that tack. You know, when you actually don't have anything of substance, we've all seen it in our lives. You just start yelling.
Just yell.
You just start yelling.
Yell your way out of the situation.
And then I don't know how it was left, you know, with some BS that, you know, he's going to go upstairs again. And
more vagary.
See what he can do.
More vagary.
And we're like, all right, who are these people? Who are they? Because I don't think we're being told the complete truth either here.
No.
And that, I'll just keep it at that. I don't think we're being told the complete truth.
Yeah.
I think you called me yesterday, and
I had a lot of time on the road, Jimmy. Right. Sorry about that.
I think you're right. I think you're...
Yeah.
I think it's... in what we talked about, I think it's a 70-30 split in favor of what you were saying. Right. I think the other 30 is a part of it, but I think 70% of it's what you're saying.
Right. And if that's the case, I'm here to say that, you know... Troy didn't mean anything. He didn't mean anything that day.
No.
He was just trying to make good fucking radio.
Just on the air. So fucking around.
So we'll see what happens today. But that was everyone was asking for an update on Twitter and stuff. So there's your update.
Yeah.
A meeting that, I don't know. I left there like just thinking this business has passed us by and we'll hang on as long as we can, but
It's a totally different animal now than it used to be, you know?
There used to be a whole bunch of shows like ours.
Yeah, remember?
It's down to us and Howard, pretty much.
Remember? There was a whole bunch of shock jock shows. Right.
And then you got a company that oversees everything, and they think what happens on, like, the 60s on 6 channel is the same shit that should be happening happening on the Opie and Anthony show.
Yeah. There's no difference between us and the fucking 60s on 6. If somebody was to say something on 60s on 6, that would fire them. It should be the same for everybody. Meanwhile, the context of this show, of things on this show would be completely different.
And if we were as boring as the guys on 60s on 6,
hey, I think
we should be.
I think Dennis Falcone is involved in 60s on 6.
But it's not the same shit.
Mr. Excitement.
Music jocks in general are really boring. They're lucky to have gigs.
Oh.
You know, if we came in here and was as boring as those guys, then we should be fired.
Well, we give you a little information about the music.
Was that it for the highlights? I think that was about it.
Yeah, that was about it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think.
I just walked out. I can't shake his hand after those meetings. I know it annoys him, but I can't fucking do it. I just leave. I just quickly leave.
Such a weird thing. I hate dealing with them.
Yeah.
Like coming in here, hanging out, having a little fun.
Yeah, because we don't see eye to eye. We never will.
No.
It's one thing that has made us successful over the years because they just don't, understand what we do.
No, they don't.
They like it when it pays off, but they don't understand what goes behind this.
Yeah.
They just don't get it.
So
and I can't look those guys in the eyes and make believe that, you know, we're all on the same page. We're not. We'll never be.
So we're just sitting waiting. And yesterday by the parking garage, I was like, you know, we're sitting here going, oh, will he be fired? Won't he? This, that. And I'm like, this is the exact situation we talk about with fired, so fired. Oh, my God, so fired.
Yeah. Right.
It's the it happened. It builds a little momentum. They get suspended. They look into it. Things go back and forth, and then fired, so fired.
Right.
I go, what is making us think? We've talked about this 1,000 times. Why do we think this is any different?
Right.
So I'm like, you know, I think fired, so fired.
Oh, yeah, I don't.
It's terrible.
Yeah, when I hear, oh, we're making a little progress here and there.
That's like...
I don't believe any of that.
That just harkens me back to the days of let's just, you know, we'll go in there, you know, you guys tell them what you know. We'll get you back on the air.
Right.
I'm like, no, you're not getting us back on the air. We're fired, so fired.
So I'm going to remain a bit optimistic. I feel a bit, I'm not sure yet.
Oh, Jimmy.
I'm just not sure.
You're
adorable.
A hopeful boy.
I am.
That's adorable.
Voted, I know.
Weren't you voted something years ago in school?
Yes.
What was it?
Boy most likely to suck a few dicks. Is that not the contest you were talking about, or the award?
No, that wasn't it.
Oh, the award, the
something
fucking...
more about being hopeful, but okay.
Oh, okay. Yeah, boy most likely to keep his chin up.
To keep a stiff upper lip.
Boy.
Don't beauty queens feel stupid walking around with that dumb crown?
Yeah, of course they do.
It's like that dumb crown. I don't know. I'm watching somebody on Fox and Friends.
And she's the sash.
Very pretty, but she's got that dumb... sparkly crown on, like, who are you?
Well, it's out of here. It's the sign of just dumb.
Yes, sign of dumb.
It really is.
You wear the symbol of dumb.
You are just dumb. Congratulations. Wear this crown.
Yeah. There's some goings on out there. I guess DQ Blizzards. What?
What happened?
I don't know. Look at that. There's Dairy Queen Blizzards out there on the
oh, really?
Fox and Friends table.
Oh, those things are good.
Oh, they look good.
Look
good.
I'm
a big
huh?
fan of the DQ.
Get somebody down there.
Oh,
scoop
a blizzard.
One of those
up. I want
look
one.
At that table filled with blizzards.
Man,
it must be so
good.
Chilly and delicious.
Dude, someone's got to slide across that table and take out the blizzards.
How funny would it
please
be?
Please do it.
Off the left of camera,
please
someone just
it.
Comes flying in.
Please do it.
Flying in on their back and just wipes the table of blizzards
just
out.
Just a nice belly slide across that table. Please do it. We need some excitement
you
today.
You'd laugh if someone knocked
off. I would lose
God.
My mind. I would not be able to broadcast for the rest of the morning.
I'd be so puzzled over there. What just happened?
Someone jumped on our ice cream.
It's very easy to. It's Fox and Fred's on 48th Street. They just have a table right next to the road filled
a
with
blizzard.
Fucking blizzards and that dummy in a crown.
Oh, God, it's funny.
So much about yourself for becoming a part of the Miss America organization, and I've been really honored to be
happy.
Miss America this year, even for 8 months.
Yeah, and the learning process, even if you don't end up to the epitome of
Miss,
what Mallory is.
You really
is
look
right.
stupid with the crown on it.
Crown
you're
just
right.
An absolute asshole.
Yeah. When you're done.
You look like you're
well,
fucking the Burger King.
Yeah, you might as well have a beanie with a propeller on it. Or
oh, you got to walk around with that.
Yeah.
And I would like to,
what does it mean?
It means nothing.
And then
she's the beauty queen. She's wearing the crown.
Be joining you guys somewhere someday.
Could she be a giant C? That's what the crown should be.
Could you dress
basis,
a little sexier? Look. I mean, she's wearing this black thing. It's up to her fucking chin.
I know. She's dressed like she's playing for the White Sox in 1920.
So let's go ahead and take a look at the country. We want to start out first in the Pacific Ocean because
that's a little weather. Thanks.
I want a fucking blizzard so bad.
Well, let's go get some blizzards.
No, I can't.
Oh, no, I can't.
I gotta go to the gym. Again.
Let's go get some blizzards.
We have someone getting
he's
them.
Going to the gym. And
are they
going to
do the belly flop
better.
Across the fucking table?
Yeah, I don't know gym, about
eating
that. Butter.
Eating butter.
What are you eating butter?
I'd like a blizzard. Yeah, I've been going to the gym and eating butter, but I'm going to break my diet.
I don't know. People are still asking questions about the Troy thing. How is Troy's situation different from when Fez threatened an intern? Yeah, that happened too, but no one took that seriously either.
Oh, this is this now.
And people want to know if what does Zito say about Troy being suspended? Supposedly, Mark Zito is totally cool with what went down that day.
Yeah,
Zito, after the fact, he was totally cool.
He feels bad about Troy being suspended. Yeah, I mean, that... I mean, 5 minutes after they got off the air, they were okay.
Right. Sucking each other's dicks, I hear.
Out of four.
Yeah.
So that's why I think it's something else that we got to be really careful about. But I think we're not being told the complete truth here.
Yeah.
About who is causing this issue.
It's a conspiracy.
It certainly
ironically
is.
Ironically enough.
Certainly is.
Mm-hmm.
So, where were we?
Oh, no. We started the show.
Beauty queens with fucking crowns. That's
with dumb crowns. Dumb fucking crown.
You're right. It just says...
Look, it's so out of place.
Dummy alert. Dummy alert.
Yes, dummy.
Dummy coming our way.
Oh, no. It does stop his fucking cancer.
Well, he's treated surgically. I believe they said he's cancer-free.
Oh, good.
He's undergoing some treatment to keep it from coming back. And him or his reps will not say what kind of big casino it was.
I hope it's not dick cancer.
Oh, no, probably, God.
Yeah, probably a little prostate action.
I went to school with a dick cancer back in...
I just want to cover how badly that flopped. I believed you. It was
more factual.
You could have covered
funny.
That by saying, "Yeah, I haven't seen him since 1975." And I went, "Oh, was he a nice guy?
Oh,
funny name to have."
Tell me about him. Yes, Jimmy.
I'd love to know.
That was a good one.
I didn't know you were joking until you stopped on the edge of the cliff with your eyes wide open.
Shit.
Fuck.
Yeah, that's terrible. I hope he's. I love Dustin Hoffman.
Yes.
Nice. All right.
Yeah, you think.
Yeah, he's totally cool.
And then Usher had
almost drowned. It's fucking
kid
scary.
Fucking goes in the pool, ends up at the bottom by the drain, and then the drain fucking like sucks him in.
Oh.
And holds him down.
He was
there.
At the bottom of the pool?
Yeah.
On the deep end?
Yeah, and the drain.
But he's only 5.
I know.
How'd he get down there?
Maybe he fell in. I don't know. But the drain fucking held him down there. That's a nightmare.
Your pool can't do that, right?
No, I shut the suction drain off of the bottom. I don't like that thing.
But why? That seems way too fucking dangerous.
Right?
Why haven't they figured that shit out?
There has to be a better way.
There has to be a better way, right?
A relief valve there or something. Something where if the, like it gets that, it should open up another valve somewhere. That doesn't
right.
You know,
oh right.
Yeah, it should be
Let's
like.
Go on
safety.
Shark Tank. I think we've got something here.
I think they make it. It's called a relief valve.
Oh.
Yeah,
damn it.
It should be put in there.
But shouldn't there be right by it too? I within a foot. But you know, a kid wouldn't have
to
do that.
No.
Honestly, yeah, like something you could do to relieve it.
Right. It was worse than just the kid. Because he says he jumped in because he saw a toy, and so he dove in to get it. And then he got stuck, and a maid and his aunt both jumped in and tried to pull him up, and they couldn't get him up
Jeez.
Out of the pool. And so two AV guys that were working in the house had to jump in and pull him out.
Damn.
Oh, wow. So
how long was he underwater?
A little while.
Is he okay?
I think
you can only survive under the water. Underwater like 30 seconds.
Oh,
that's about
they
it.
They had to do some CPR and
that's
stuff,
it.
Didn't they?
30, yeah, but you're not holding your breath. You're not ready to go underwater if you're
Hell
5.
No.
You don't know,
no.
like,
yeah,
you're
you
not taking the deepest breath you can.
He's in the ICU, but they think he'll be okay.
That's scary.
So fucking these two guys, if it wasn't for these two guys, they could be dead.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, because the two women couldn't get him up.
So
yeah.
The guys just had to fucking probably rip, like, pull as hard as they could.
Yeah.
You know what? Also, you should know... Had to, like, shut your shit off immediately. Like, shut the pumps down. Shut the fucking thing down. That way you could... People are very silly when it comes to machines and mechanical things. And I don't mean... You don't have to know every technical aspect of everything you own. But when something is could be life-threatening, you should really know how it works. Like, people should have a basic understanding of an automobile... How the fucking car works, how the brakes work, things like that. And a pool, you should have a basic understanding of how the pumps work and where water is sucking in, where it's blowing out. Like, just shit like that, you should fucking know. Basic knowledge of electrical equipment, just things like that.
Bad, I don't know nothing. Oh. They want to hit the do for me button. Hey, do for me, do for me.
Oh,
hey, I get in the car, I get gas. What do I know? The tire breaks down. Hey, do for me, do for me.
The do for me button.
Yeah, nobody knows nothing.
Ah, you're right there, regular Joe.
Yeah, they don't know how to fix nothing. Hey, you come fix. You come fix. Do
you
for me, do
it.
For me.
You do it, Joe.
Yeah, hey, Joe, come over here. Do for me, do for me.
Oh,
I'm on my break.
Oh, no, they brought a blizzard.
No. Thank you.
Did you see anyone attempting to get ready to take out the table?
You should have launched yourself. How is it?
Yeah, there's cameras all over. That's why you do it. Who is this guy?
Let him have it. You have it.
You heard that, right, Sam?
Yeah.
This is what I'm talking about. The business has passed us by.
There's cameras all over. People would have seen.
It's Fox News.
That's why we don't want to do it in the middle of the darkness.
If you do it when no one's watching, did you really do it?
Thank you, Anthony.
Yes.
Like he's going to wait until the shot's over. Camera's not on, is it?
Okay. Yeah. All right, now I'll do it.
This is what I'm talking about.
It's crazy that the instinct.
We're in the minority. The business has passed us by. The kid actually said, there's too many cameras around.
Meanwhile, in the old days, we would have gotten a phone call from him. All right, I'm on.
Of course.
All right, wait until we see the shot.
Of course.
And then we'd have sat here and gone, okay, do it now.
Right.
And you'll launch across the table.
Right.
We'd have all laughed.
What about if someone just goes and just says, I'm going to flip shit and just fucking
just flip the table over like a pissed off individual?
He's smart. Tyler's smart because he knows that he would have gotten in trouble.
Yes.
And the company would have cracked down
right.
because an assault was made against ice cream.
He's there.
And ice cream is technically part of a cow, so it's animal assault.
Right.
By the way, I had two bites of my Blizzard and gave it back to him. Two little mouthfuls. It's better than coming. It's better than coming.
DQ Blizzards are ridiculous.
This has like pieces of cookie in it.
Yeah, I can't.
Yeah. Oreo cookie.
I guess cookies and
cream.
Yeah,
two bites. I had two bites.
So good.
Here, have mine.
Done. No, I give it away to John.
Who wants this one?
To Tyler.
I'll bet E-Rock does.
E-Rock or E-Rock. Jackie or somebody.
Are you good for a good?
No, it's got chocolate in it.
Oh yeah, he doesn't like chocolate.
Well, how about Jackie or somebody?
Imagine
else?
How fatty would really be if he liked chocolate.
You're saying with his
Jackie
complete lack of ability to control himself, if he had chocolate?
No, if it had steak in it, I'd be all over
right.
it.
Right. You're lucky you don't like chocolate. Holy fuck, we'd be cutting you out of your home.
Oh, my God.
Young intern Jackie is coming to get it.
Little Jackie. Jackie, how many days you got left here?
Three.
That's it?
Yeah.
You're going to be up in Rochester for the PGA tournament?
Back to Rochester?
She's a Rochester girl.
My dad got tickets for it.
The PGA Championship?
And for the LPGA.
Yeah.
LPGA?
Yeah,
that's garbage.
Both of them are there.
Is that the gay golf one? Oh, no, that's LPGA.
How's the Blizzard?
It's
pretty goddamn
good. I've only
been
to one time.
Yeah.
Did you rent DQ by us.
You rent your home for the PGA Championship?
Oh, that looks good. No.
People rent their homes up there, Ant.
Do they?
Yeah, for the golfers and shit. You can make like a quick 20, 25 grand for the week.
But it's in Pittsford.
Huh?
Yeah, which is the fancy part of Rochester. It's where the rich people live.
Ah,
I would have thought it was just the opposite. I would have thought the fancy part was Cherry, and then Pittsford was the shithole. Boo. B-double-O. Oh, yuck.
Shit.
Are you going to go to Oak Hill?
No. I hate golf.
Oh, boo.
It's too boring for me. I'm a football or hockey person.
Damn.
Bills fan?
Yes.
Oh.
I already gone to two games.
Did the Jets actually announce that Sanchez is going to be starting?
That figures.
We're going to do this again?
It's good, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're going to do it again.
We're going to do it again with Sanchez? Are you serious?
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, enjoy the blizzard.
There you go. Enjoy your blizzard.
Young gal likes
Three
a blizzard.
Days.
Something terrible. About a young gal eating ice cream just makes you want to lose your job.
We're doing the big celebration for Jackie Friday.
You usually throw food at interns.
No.
Well, that's
you just
true.
Said ta-ta and enjoy your blizzard, Jackie.
Yeah, why not? She's a good hard worker.
You got her a nice treat.
Absolutely.
I don't want to go to waste.
When did we throw food at an intern?
I had food thrown at me. You threw eggs at a kid because they weren't hard boiled.
Exactly.
Food and I do who remember. Did?
All of you.
Yeah. I don't like hard-boiled eggs.
I do remember someone's shoe being...
chocolate. A chocolate-covered strawberry being thrown in the rich boy's
yes,
shoe.
Yes, yes, the rich
a nice
boy.
Nice suede shoe.
Yes.
Shut up.
Yeah. That
all right, isn't... so, all right, there was a couple... And none of us got in trouble for that, by the way.
No.
That's assaulting.
It's true, with a piece of fruit.
Mm-hmm. That could have done some damage.
It was a drive-by fruiting.
How does that taste, by the way, that DQ?
It's fucking great.
I'll tell you, a blizzard is an oral home run.
Oh,
it's just terrific.
Oh, my God, is it?
It really is.
All right, now where were we?
Oh, right, okay.
Golf.
Crowns make girls look stupid.
Yes. Crowns make girls look stupid.
Blizzard.
Here comes Dummy.
Blizzards are great. We're completely in another world because fucking the intern didn't want to throw himself on the blizzard table with the cameras running. Perish that thought.
But then the other one comes in and we're like, oh, you little delight, have a bite.
We have 3 days left of any morale left in this fucking
show.
There is a time.
This show is going to be, sorry, Sam, this show is going to be the opening scene in Saving Private Ryan come 2 weeks from now.
Yes.
2 weeks, a week.
Oh,
not even.
Yeah, this,
oh, man.
It's terrible.
It's going to be sad.
There was a time when, like, you'd literally have to have, you'd have interns fighting over which one of them got to dive through the DQ table.
Right?
Like, interns would come in, no, I'm going to go down and do it. I'm going to go
down and do it.
I'm going to do it. No. All right.
And now it's like, no, there's cameras. There's too many cameras.
We'd be all nervous when he calls up. I'm here down by the DQ table. Okay, wait. We'll wait until we see the live shot here. Coordinate the whole thing. And then we'd get in trouble, but
it
would be a little bit of trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'd be like, you can't do that, guys. Now the Fox people are all mad at us.
We have to pay for those blizzards.
I don't even know. We'd probably get in a lot of trouble now. In the old days, it was a little trouble.
Now it would be
a little trouble.
They'd arrest the kid.
It would be some type of terroristic event.
Right.
Like they would prosecute him on some kind of fucking Homeland Security law.
Mm. They'd probably block you from doing red eye.
Right. I wouldn't be able to do red eye anymore.
How funny would it be if that intern just ran down and did that and then got 2 years in jail for it.
That would roll.
We still wouldn't remember his name.
Yeah, there's some kind of fucking Homeland Security fucking Patriot Act law that says if the news is on and you do something, it's terrorism. They send him to Guantanamo.
He's fucking waterboarded.
They take his family out with a drone.
Right.
Yeah, it's just bad.
I have no information.
They're waterboarding our intern.
I thought they got rid of waterboarding. That's what we've told the media. We're still doing this. Logan Field on Twitter writes, dude, banana split blizzard, unreal, get one.
I bet.
Can we get some banana split blizzards?
Anything banana-y is great.
Love bananas and ice cream.
And anything that is strawberry banana flavor, like strawberry banana, orange juice.
Love. All good.
It's so fucking good.
I prefer a good cookie and cream. That's me.
Oh, well.
It's fun
good
when you get
a butter flavor.
When you get a blizzard at Dairy Queen, because before they give it to you, they turn it upside down.
Why? That's stupid.
To show you that it's thick.
Doesn't come out.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh, wow, really?
Aha, stupid. And he just dribbled some of his blizzard.
I just came
all over himself. And I couldn't have been happier if it was like 50-year-old dynamite drippings.
It's nerve-wracking in this studio. You can't even drip a little blizzard on your pants.
I saw, without being called stupid.
Stupid.
I saw blizzard drip on Ann's pants and console, and I felt like I just fucking, I won Powerball last night.
$425 million.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Something like that, right?
I'll wind up fucking trying it. You know. That kind of money?
Yesterday, I'll buy one today because I work out by this fucking thing, by this lotto place. So I might always buy one when I win.
Well.
You do, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to win. I've already started making plans.
Positive mental attitude.
Absolutely.
I'm going to win.
Who's calling Bruce Willis an asshole today?
I guess Debbie Moore.
I believe
Sylvester?
Sylvester Stallone. They're making Expendables 3.
And Bruce is out.
Bruce is out. Harrison Ford is in, I guess.
What?
Yeah.
Is that about?
I don't know. But, I guess Sly was saying, that this is great. He's, been wanting to do this for years, I guess, working with Harrison and not working with Bruce Willis. And then he tweeted something that said, something being greedy and lazy is a surefire career suicide. What was the line?
Yeah, the first tweet was Willis out, Harrison Ford in. Great news. Been waiting for this for years. And then the next tweet, greedy and lazy, a sure formula for career failure.
Career failure. Bruce Willis.
Hard to say career failure.
Yeah, he's had
a
great career.
It's probably not going to at this point. That's not a risk anymore.
We've heard things about Bruce Willis.
Yeah, Kevin Smith was not in love with him either.
A lot of people have awful things about working with Bruce Willis. Yeah, lazy and greedy. I guess Sly didn't want to fucking deal with him anymore.
In other movie news, the Lone Ranger, one of the biggest busts
ever, right?
In recent memory. Mm-hmm.
The Lone Ranger.
It's cost Disney $190 million.
Johnny Depp.
Well, he's blaming the critics.
He's blaming the critics.
He's like, you know what? It's a great movie, but the critics killed us.
I think that was Armie Hammer blaming the critics.
No, I heard Johnny Depp this morning.
Oh, Armie Hammer did it, too.
He did, too? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they're probably right to a certain degree. I mean, that's what hurts the movie.
But people find these movies eventually.
If
it's a good movie, they find it.
Even if the critics say it sucks. Because
they're saying it's bombing everywhere.
Yeah, even overseas. I mean,
overseas. It's just, it's not finding an audience anywhere.
That's fucking huge loss.
Which surprises me, because I saw the trailer and it looked cool as fuck.
Yes.
I didn't see the movie. But that's the trailer... But it looked cool.
I think it's such a weird thing because no one really gives a shit about the Lone Rangers.
But I wanted to see it. It looked good. I'm like, well, how come no one thinks this looks good but me?
It looked good.
Jackie?
It looked really cool, but no one bought into it.
I don't think anyone cares about the Lone Ranger.
Is it one of those things that's just too old no matter how you reboot it? No one's going to care.
I think you're right. It's too old an idea and a concept, the cowboy hat and the fucking mask.
Like Three Stooges flopped, because that was too old.
That was
too.
A funny movie. Honestly, that was a funny movie.
I said that, and I got bashed for it, I'll stand by it. The fucking reboot of the Three Stooges wasn't bad at all. I found myself laughing a lot.
And we hated that they were rebooting that movie.
Will Sasso's fucking hilarious. And the guy that did Larry, what the fuck was he from?
The guy from Will and Grace.
He was from Will and Grace. He did a great Larry Fine.
Yeah. Okay.
The Mo guy was good. Yeah, it was just fucking funny.
That was a funny movie. And Larry, Jesus, was good as the nun.
Oh, Larry David.
Larry David. Jesus, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I found it pretty funny.
Sometimes I'll say brain fart.
Oh. Yeah, it's just too old a
but I think
concept.
Disney figured that like Pirates of the Caribbean became this amazing thing, and you'd think that you know Pirates doesn't have this big franchise with it.
People kind of like Pirates.
Yeah, especially if they're from Pittsburgh.
But he dressed up like a pirate though for the Lone Ranger.
Yeah, that's
just another
thing.
Pirate. He looks like a pirate on a fucking horse.
His character's a little odd.
A bird on his head.
I think he's got to play another regular role because everybody is seeing him.
Too many characters.
Yeah,
right?
He's just playing a fucking weirdo and everything.
Right.
What? Oh, he doesn't talk in this one. He just goes, "Mrr." So people like, you know, I think you got to balance it a little bit to keep yourself interesting. I'll have some.
No more Blizzard. I had enough.
Yeah, I think really that's good. What it is. People get sick of seeing you in the same tone. I tried to repeat my point, because I thought it was good. I didn't get enough accolades for it.
Yes. Yeah, he's got something going on where he's got to do regular acting.
Yeah, he's
got
to mix it up.
You know?
Third time.
Sort of the wacky. Yeah, third time.
Do something that's not Disney or Tim Burton.
Right.
There you go.
Yeah, play like a regular guy.
Fourth time.
No, but I'm saying, I was actually going to give an example.
Oh.
Yeah, play a guy who's fired from a shoe store.
Oh.
Because you keep picking the shoe up by the toe and smashing old women in the teeth with boot heels. You keep cracking new boots on old women's teeth.
So he keeps getting fired.
Yeah, he gets fired a lot.
I could see that happening.
Well, the food has arrived, so we should take a break.
Has.
We got lots to do today.
Man.
Anthony Weiner, I don't know, man. I think I might be back on board.
You have to be.
Starting to like him again.
When you have nothing to lose, you open yourself up to a certain freedom to just honestly be yourself and just say fucking shit.
And he said
as
some
a politician.
Shit yesterday.
Fucking funny.
We'll play it for you next.
Yeah.
And you know what? I got killed on Twitter, and I think they're right.
Uh-oh.
I think Wiener and the pig part of Wiener and the pig wasn't as bad.
Not at all.
It wasn't that bad.
A lot.
It wasn't as bad.
Wasn't bad.
Coming off that
I was
beach
really hoping
shoot,
to see
though.
some more of a disaster. There was a couple of the clips, you know, parts of the clips that were a little rough. But in general, I think she gets a big-time passing grade.
I liked her
fair
in her blue underwear.
No.
Oh, God.
I did.
I'm dying to see her vagina.
That was a little rough.
Blue underwear.
I don't know.
Are you just dying to see that vag? You think it's puffy? Big, like, mound?
I do, yeah.
but she could go out for a blizzard sometime. She wouldn't mind having a little dessert.
Oh, she would love it.
She'd love it.
She wasn't that bad. Fair enough. Got to be fair. Fuck. Legs are big, though. Come on.
She does have big fucking...
They're big.
It's nice, though.
Big legs.
They're big.
Big fat ass.
Big legs.
Give me the photo. She that ass.
All right, we're going to eat.
Yeah.
Sublime, right? Oh, no.
Is this not Sublime?
No.
It's Sublime.
Oh, okay.
Dude, smoke two joints!
No reason, just playing it.
I like Sublime, even though I don't know who they are, obviously. Fuck.
They were really good, man.
What about Sublemon?
Fuck yeah! Well, how about Battleship Lime, you cocksucker?
Oh, because of submarine.
Fuck yeah.
I was listening to some Pop 2K. They want me to be more of a company guy, so.
Oh, okay.
I was listening to Pop 2K.
Oh, Pop 2K.
It's all those pop songs that were really fucking huge, but now they're old songs because they're about 2 or 3 years old.
Oh.
From the last 10 years.
So what were you hearing?
I don't know, because... they bleep out so much shit and have, like, scratches over the bad words. I don't even know what the song is anymore.
It's useless at that point.
There was one song. I'm like, why even bother playing the song?
It is. It's worthless to even play the song at that point.
And I wanted to make a mental note to tell you what particular song, but I forgot. Sorry. Uh-huh. But I guess the thing is they put a scratch in. Like a where the bitch is and the oh, that was a hoe. That's the N word.
There's a joint. Talking about drugs. Guns.
Why bother?
Yeah.
Isn't it? Why can't you just play the songs? What happened?
It's not an XL channel, I bet. Mm-hmm. Oh boy.
Well, they gotta fucking.
I'll be on that XL channel.
People do complain like crazy
about curses.
Yep.
Because they're driving with their young
listeners.
I have my young son in the car.
Yeah, if you're with your kids or whatever, listen to a pop song.
Okay. All right. That fair enough.
Fair enough, sir.
But the song, they were for bitch and for hoe.
Yeah.
Those aren't curse words.
No.
You should hear what I mean. Even on the comedy channel,
right?
Like the clean comedy channel, people complain if a comedian says God.
Oh, God.
Exactly. Yeah, I've seen emails.
Oh, by the way, for the record, if you're one of those people that writes G/D because you won't write God, you should chop your fucking typing hand off because you're an asshole.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Back to the discussion, folks.
Well, the theme today is the world has passed. Now I'm going with the world has passed us by.
Yeah.
It started with radio has passed us by. We have no business being in radio anymore. But we'll hang in there because we're getting paid a shitload of money.
Yeah.
But also the world is passing us by. Who gets offended because there's a fuck in their comedy?
Not a fuck. I mean anything.
The Midwest.
Well, you said God, right?
Yeah. God, whatever.
I bet there are a lot of people from the Midwest.
Right.
God-fearing people. Exhausted. From the Bibble Belt.
So does SiriusXM, because I am trying to be more of a company guy. Do they have
good
like a comedy channel that is completely uncensored?
Oh, yeah, Raw Dog.
Yeah, Raw Dog is totally uncensored.
But do they play comedy bits? I don't know.
Yes. Constantly.
Okay, yes. Good.
You can go on there and say, fudge, heck, darn, and what the hey.
All right, good then.
Yeah.
All right. So there's a little hope left.
Yeah, they have the uncensored, and then they have Laugh USA, which is completely censored, totally clean.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think that's smart.
No, that's fair enough, at least.
Yeah.
But Pop 2K, I want to hear these songs. I want to hear the words they're scratching out.
Yeah.
The words, man.
Right.
There's no uncensored pop channel.
It might have been the London Bridges one by Fergie.
Fergie.
I like Fergie.
Fergie.
Is there any...
Fergie.
Is there any scratches in that song?
I would think so. I mean, the whole song is about... getting dick.
Whoa!
Every song is about getting dick, even when you listen to the 40s on 4 or 4 on 40s. They just were a little more clever about it.
We're getting some dick.
It makes listening to the 40s channel a lot of fun. Try it on your own time. Just know that every song is about trying to get your dick in a hole.
The Andrews Sisters singing
all
about
that.
Dick.
Yes. They just were very clever. Yeah. They had workarounds, but it's all about you're just trying to finger pop a broad somewhere. But they just make them like romantical
before you get sent overseas.
Right?
Yeah.
You're just trying
boogie,
to get
boogie,
a little
bugle
tail.
Boy. It's all about putting your fucking bugle in a chick and going.
I'm telling you, it makes that channel a lot of fun.
Yeah,
because they talk about the innocence. There was no innocence. Since the dawn of time, guys have been trying to finger pop broads.
That's why that old school porno looks really funny.
Right.
The old black and white fucking,
right.
They all look like Miss Crabtree from fucking Little Rascals.
Right.
Only naked, big, hairy, bouge. Yeah.
Give me a 40 song. I'll prove my point.
40. That fucking Lauren Hill's in prison.
Really?
That's fucked up, right?
Why? For
tax? Yeah.
She's annoying anyway. Good
she was just an annoying beyond.
Well, she was always a little strange. She's kind of militant, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, oh, my God. That's. She used to be sexy. What happened to
her? She was in the Fugees. The Fugees.
Oh, wow. Well, don't take off that picture of fucking of Haywood Nelson. I want to see.
Haywood Nelson.
She looks like fucking Haywood Nelson.
Oh, God damn. Yeah.
Now you brought up something else that is my pet peeve.
Yeah.
The Fugees.
The Fugees.
The Fugees had.
Fugees.
And she had that beautiful version of Kill Me Softly, but then they had to do the.
One time.
One time. Two time. Three time.
One time.
And then all that rapping shit. She had a beautiful voice on that song.
It's a great song.
It's kind
one
of,
time.
Yeah, it's kind of like Jay-Z. See, all right, let's go with this.
Nice.
Lovely. She should have just remade the song.
Right.
Nice.
Maybe it's not your thing, but you could respect the voice.
But she was trying to get play on like hip hop radio, not easy listening.
You don't understand
then
this.
Go to easy listening.
Exactly.
That's not much more money.
Ring the bell when you think the song is ruined. So far, it's perfect. Beautiful.
It's already ruined. It's a white woman song.
Sam.
Beautiful.
Beautiful.
I like this.
You don't like that they added a beat to it? No.
No, actually, I'm still in.
Yeah.
I'll be honest with you. I'm still in.
All right.
Updating the song a little bit. I'm okay with that.
Anything even a little bit hip-hop, man. It's like, I'm out.
I'm still in.
Who did the original? Roberta Flack?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Don't give me any flack, Jim.
I didn't hear you.
Don't give me
one time. Why?
One time of what?
Two times. I used to know somebody that used to call black people two times because of this song. You go, I like it. Yeah, it was a couple of two times.
That's funny.
Yeah. Racist.
But it's unnecessary.
Yeah,
it doesn't add anything.
Why would they do that?
The hip-hop beat adds something to the song.
You wouldn't know Wyclef is in the song unless he did that.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah,
Wyclef.
He was feeling a little left out. He said, fuck that.
Bow, 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 bow.
Sounds like Robbie.
But he doesn't go all in with the rap, right? Like other songs.
Not in this song.
Like Jay-Z ruining that fucking New York song.
It was his song.
Yeah, but he ruined it because that chick was beautiful with the New York part.
It was just a hook. She put out the song without rapping, and it wasn't a hit.
It was beautiful, though, Sam Roberts.
You didn't even hear it. What song
I
was that?
I certainly did. I don't know. This chick had this cool song about
Alicia
New York, and then Jay-Z had to, like,
rap
about all the boroughs in it.
I hear you.
Jay-Z's song.
No, it was the chick's song.
Oh, please. Everyone knows Alicia Keys was the bulk of that song.
She put out a version without Jay-Z.
What just happened?
E-Rock's
mixing. E-Rock's mixing.
E-Rock's mixing. Yeah, mix master.
Yeah.
E-Rock.
Yeah.
Holy
yeah.
shit.
Mix master mush.
this is like damn, not needed.
That was flawless, E-Rock.
Yeah. That was a good mix. Called DJ Who Kid.
Yeah.
I don't think he's an amazing rapper, man.
Jay-Z?
I know. It's crazy. I don't. Eminem's a much better rapper than he is.
No, you're like, not.
Yeah, he is.
He's DJ Chew Kid.
Chew. I thought you were going to say Chew Cud.
No.
Damn, E-Rock. Run P.I.G.
Oh, God.
Walk DMC.
Yeah. I heard the N-word. I don't appreciate that.
No, I don't appreciate that either.
I don't like that at all.
See? Beautiful.
This part.
This is beautiful.
This is the part everyone likes.
Right.
Because it's the hook.
Beautiful.
Fairly typical.
Yeah, motherfucker.
Now you're doing the Y Club thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Two times.
Right.
Oh, see, he's back.
It's his song.
Let her at least do her part.
Yeah.
You ever look up lyrics online, Sam Roberts?
Yeah.
It's very simple with me. If the lyrics fit on one sheet of paper, most likely I like the song. All right?
Okay. Rule of thumb, I like that.
Jay-Z, this song has to be 10 to 20 pages.
Listen to him. It's a pamphlet.
Yeah. You can't keep up.
Anyway, where were we?
There are a lot of lyrics to the song.
Just got to mention every single thing in New York.
Yeah,
he's
no
appreciating
kidding.
The city.
Everything. In real time, too.
Right.
Here comes then the we took the subway. Selfish.
Did
he hear Selfish? Her beautiful voice, and he's still in the background. Yeah, that's right. That's what I said. Let her sing her part, at least.
Selfish.
Oh, God. Back to this.
Oh, my God.
Page 8 of the song.
Page 8.
Oh, well, she was hungry. Go ahead.
So what happened to Lauryn Hill? I remember where
tax
we were.
Tax evasion.
Yep. Yeah.
Little tax evasion.
How many years?
She got 2 years, I think.
Yeah, I think that's right.
And it's pretty minimum security.
Do you have to pay your taxes after that?
I think
that's a good question.
The fuck out of here.
Cause it,
yeah,
when you take
penalties.
The 2 years?
No. 2 years to like get out of your tax
yes.
bill?
Yes. Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Because you got to not pay your taxes for a while. So all those years you don't pay your taxes, then you do a quick 2 years. You got a lot of extra money laying around.
2 fucking years. You know what? On day one, 2 years is a long fucking time.
Yeah. You only do 2 days, the day you get in and the day you get out.
God damn it, Jim, you're so right. Fuck.
Unless, of course, you're Andy Dufresne.
Oh.
Yeah.
I put his same voice in every movie.
Every fucking
movie. Got it.
Movie.
Mm-hmm. Well, he was good in Glory. That Denzel scene with Morgan Freeman.
That was a good fucking movie right there.
It was a great fucking scene.
Man. I can't tell you a movie he was good in.
Morgan Freeman?
Yeah, just because he...
Morgan Freeman.
Just because of your point. He plays the same guy. It's hard to, like, say, oh, no, this was the movie where he was really good.
He was good in...
He's a great actor, obviously, but when you play the same fucking...
I liked him in Seven.
Yeah.
Seven?
The pimp movie, he played a pimp in a movie he was very good in.
Yeah.
He was good in Shawshank.
Shawshank he was really good in, too. Yeah, I gotta give you that.
Well, that was early on, too, and before he really started playing the Morgan Freeman
And
role.
He was doing the narration the whole time, so that's very Morgan Freeman, yeah.
Right.
And Glory he was great in.
Yeah.
You're right.
That was really good.
Fuck it.
Driving Miss Daisy?
He sucked in that movie.
I'm just trying to drive you to the stove!
Take you to Piggly Wiggly.
Piggly Wiggly.
And he called her an old white cunt and hit her with a fucking birch branch. No one could believe it. He smacked the back of her head, knocked her fucking flowered hat off with a birch branch. You old fake cunt.
Well, breaking news out of the NFL. Travis should come back in here for this.
Well,
the NFL, thank God they're doing this.
Yes.
Thank God. The NFL will crack down on celebrations again.
Good.
Thank God.
Good.
Because every guy hates that.
You know, the league that has murderers playing in it has a problem with, what, touchdown celebrations?
Touchdown
and other things?
What is the problem with a touchdown celebration? What
the fans love that shit.
Of course they do.
Why do they have to have this highbrow shit in sports?
Yeah, they think it's sportsmanship. This sacred ground.
Gives a fuck.
Yeah.
Sportsmanship.
What's that?
Half the players are fucking, yeah, on parole or...
drunk driving, fucking...
did horrible things, kill people,
hitting,
fucking...
hitting their ladies with purses. That's in the paper today.
Beat dogs to death.
Beat dogs to death. All that crazy shit. But let's make sure we don't spin the ball after a good play.
Don't fucking raise the roof in the end zone. I'm going to raise the roof.
As first noted by Pro Football Talk, reports out of multiple camps have officials warning players that they intend to more strictly enforce the unsportsmanlike conduct penalties already on the books.
Unsportsmanlike conduct? What's acceptable? A spike? Can you spike the ball? Look at this fucking grab that shit. We're gonna fucking what?
That includes. This is the shit you can't do.
Yeah.
Sack dances.
Sack dance. Is that when you grab your ball bag and start doing the jig?
Oh yeah.
Why am I doing it now? Grabbing my ball bag, dancing.
But who gets offended by a sack dance?
Go.
The player it happened to?
It's too bullying.
Too fucking bad.
It's bullying.
Because then that player is going to go, all right, he's going to fucking try a little harder to show that guy up. And then as a fan, you're like, oh, fuck, this is pretty cool.
Yeah, and then before you know it,
shit could be going
they're
down.
Shanking each other out there on the field.
I don't know him, so who cares?
Yeah, fuck it.
Sack dances, home run swing.
What?
What? So guys, after they throw, make a touchdown, they do a home run swing? That's just fun to watch.
It's so annoying that you can't do that stuff.
What do? You fucking like grab like you have a bat and go, wham!
Yeah, like look what I just did.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, like Chief Nakahoma.
Oh.
You can't do the Incredible Hulk anymore?
Is that where you just go, ah, like you flex?
Well, that would be the, probably with the ear thing,
right? That's
the
Hulk Hogan.
That's Hulk Hogan. That's
oh, the Incredible Hulk, immortal. I'm sorry, right. Oh, yeah, so the famous, yeah, you're right.
Why the fuck can't you do any of
that
stuff?
Like go like, ah! You can't do that.
So what? You see an amazing play, and then like these guys have to control themselves. That's so stupid.
They should only be able to do what they did like in the fucking 20s, where they get in the end zone and have to kneel down on one knee and plant the ball in front of them.
Right.
Bank.
Touchdown. That'll be a problem eventually.
That'll be a problem. Yeah.
Spiking the ball.
You can't spike it.
Spinning the ball.
Holy, what fucking babies.
Throwing.
Spiking has been a fucking, like, a mainstay.
Throwing or shoving the ball. You know how you throw the ball into the stands?
Yeah.
What babies?
Can't shove the ball.
Pointing.
You can't point?
Pointing the ball, whatever that means. What?
I think when you have it in your hand, you go, yeah!
Okay.
Yeah! Motherfucker!
Who's getting offended by this?
It's amazing what fucking babies
do. Do you realize this is a sport where most of the guys will never see old age, right?
Because they're beating their heads
in. They're never going to see old age, and if they're lucky enough to get to old age, they're not going to remember anything. You're right, because of head injuries. But this is the problem.
You know who started this shit?
Who?
I told this to Keith Robinson last night. Uh-oh. I believe it was our own Tom Landry.
Tom
who
Landry.
Who used to get mad at Butch Davis. I'm going by memory here. But I think it was Butch Davis who he first cracked down on.
Tom Landry, the guy with the hat?
Yeah. I think it was him.
Yeah.
Who began, he didn't want Butch Davis celebrating in the end zone, his own player.
Does anyone know the other side of this? Why they don't want this shit around?
Don't know.
Because this obviously seems ridiculous.
They're game purists.
And I can't imagine there's a lot of fans that are like, yeah, fuck yeah. We needed, you know, save the purity of the game here. We all love seeing this
Not
stuff.
Not the fans. The fans don't care. There'll probably be one or two dickbags going, why is there's no place for that in the fucking game.
It's never the majority and what they want. Why?
No.
Fuck, you'd lose your mind if you're at a game and you see this shit.
Yeah, what about Tebowing? If you make it a religious thing.
Right. Pointing the ball. Verbal taunting. The military salute. Standing over an opponent prolonged with provocation, or dancing.
That's everything, isn't it?
Yeah, they're pretty much, you score your fucking touchdown.
You're supposed to just...
And run to the sideline.
You're supposed to just hand the ball nicely to the ref.
Right.
No smiling.
Yes, don't smile.
And then the article goes on to say, oh, I'm sorry, you actually like those things and think they make the game better? So does Carolina's Steve Smith, who for a decade has been punctuating touchdowns by spinning the football. Spinning, it seems, will come in for particular scrutiny. So they're really
spinning,
making sure you don't spin the ball. Smith said he plans to keep on doing his signature ball spin despite an emphasis by officials to crack down on taunting this year. We're working it out, said Smith, adding he might have to alter his spin. This is just nonsense.
Hello, ball!
Officials have been told to penalize players who spin the ball at or in the vicinity of opponents. Update, an NFL spokesperson writes to let us know that the crackdown on spinning won't apply to touchdown celebrations, but only as the team is moving the ball down the field.
Who spins the ball when you're moving it down the field?
I don't know.
Look at that.
Not a lot where it would really be a problem.
None of this is a problem.
It was 7 years ago that the NFL first banned props and group celebrations, as well as the throat slash, machine gun salute. Sexually suggestive gestures. Oh, that would be the, what's his name?
Like there? X-Pac.
The X-Pac shit. Prolonged gyrations or stomping on a team logo. You're not even allowed to stomp on a team logo?
No.
Oh, I'm telling you, the theme today is this whole world is passing us by.
We're coming apart.
And I mean all of us.
Yeah.
All of us.
Everyone.
The fuck is this all about? More PC shit?
More PC stuff, definitely. It comes off as bullying. It comes off as bullying.
And what is it? Because of the kids?
Probably.
Kids see this shit and that's bad?
I bet. Probably is. It's bullying. It goes to everywhere, though. The cubicles at work, you're not allowed to hang up things. And,
right.
You know? Oh, I'd like to put the American flag here. Well, that's going to offend that person. It's all about offending. And
life is amazing. You know, you go through your day with, you know, your dumb issues and problems, but in the end, life is amazing.
Yeah.
It's a ridiculous miracle that you're even here. And then we as a society, as human beings, decide to try to make it as boring as fuck.
Yeah, and just like put so many little regulations in place that don't mean anything. Oh.
It drives me insane.
Oh, our freedoms are gone.
And then you got Jay-Z ruining fucking beautiful voices.
It's his song.
See, that should be banned.
Jay-Z?
Rap guys ruining beautiful voices should be banned.
Yeah, beautiful songs.
Let the beautiful voice fucking sing.
New York!
That's what I'm talking about. Brooklyn. You don't need to comment about what she's singing.
The Knicks, the Nets.
Right.
Sometimes people like a little rap mixed in with R&B. It's hip-hop.
Well, could we like at least come to an understanding? At least let her finish her beautiful voice part before he starts in with his dumb shit again.
People like hearing Jay-Z's voice. My man's still there.
Don't worry, he's there.
He's the hype man. He's the MC.
You're Jay-Z. Relax. It's gonna be okay. Let the chick sing her part without you fucking jumping in.
Holland Tunnel.
Right.
That's Alicia Keys.
I call her the beautiful voice.
And that ass.
She's got a wacky body, that Alicia Keys.
It's a little rough.
Wacky body.
She's sitting on that piano too long.
Yeah, that piano bench has done a world of hurt.
It softened up those butt muscles.
You could tell she's been playing that piano for a long time.
And it's spreading out a little wider
Jesus.
These days.
Jesus.
Well, I don't know. Oh. See, the bikini confuses you. And then she has the tiny boobs on top of
she
it.
She has.
Wow, she's
some saddlebags on her.
Her body is not that great.
And look at her ass. It's just
Alicia Keys.
Alicia Keys.
Let me see your ass, Sam.
Her face is very pretty, but
it's all out of proportion.
She has a nice rump. Nice big rump. No. Smack it there. Smack, smack, smack. You've been naughty. Smack, smack. No one. Smack, 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 smack.
That's a good song, too.
Oh, boy. Oh, yeah.
You're going to tell me that's not nice?
No.
That big, juicy rump?
Jimmy.
She's a little bigger than I like, but I mean, come on. You got to do it.
Those pictures.
You got to do it.
Show him the first picture. The one you had before that.
Am I right or wrong, Sam?
You're right. You're correct.
Look, see.
New York.
Nothing wrong with a gal with hips, is there?
No, legs are getting a little thicker than I care for, but not thick enough where I would not go with it. I mean, I would absolutely bring her into my bedroom and rub marmalade on her vagina and lick it off before the ants got us.
Ooh, that sounds romantic.
Yeah.
There's ants in your bedroom?
There are, yes. I would rub scented marmalade, orange marmalade.
Oh, it looks like her thighs go right, taper right into her calves.
Yeah.
I don't know. She's just got a weird little body on her. So.
Yeah, she's a little
beautiful
like a
face, though.
Very pretty girl.
And a wonderful voice.
And a voice like an angel. What are you going to say?
If you could filter out the Jay-Z shit, you could hear that she has a beautiful voice.
It was his song. Mm-hmm.
Play the part again, but why did shut up until she's done? That's all I'm asking.
Just hyping it up a little bit.
He doesn't need to. He found a chick with an amazing voice. Let her sing.
She did it without him.
He's
and it
commenting.
Was not
he's doing play-by-play as she's singing.
Right. Who says that's... When did that become acceptable?
Just play-by-play going on.
Just talk over her fucking song.
That's what you do in hip-hop.
Hip-hop.
They're insecure.
Rapping over records.
Hip-hop guys are insecure, it's obvious.
Yeah.
Just about keeping the party going.
Yeah. Why do they sing about the club? Why is the club an amazing place?
It's amazing. The club stinks.
What's so amazing about the club?
Because that's where they get down.
Where you get the bub. They pop bottles. You're popping bottles, yo.
And then if you dance real well, then you're a superstar? But where are you a superstar? Just in the club?
At the club.
In the club. Exactly.
But then what does that mean?
You could roll on Molly. You could pop bottles. You could do whatever you want. You could rock some Tom Ford. Whatever.
It literally is such childish shit. Like, it's all the same. Yeah, exactly. You could pop some.
And then you got to go on the dance floor and show your shit off.
Yeah, what
it's
the
like,
fuck
okay,
is that about?
Will that get you a promotion at work?
Yo, I'm having a bottle of, a bottle of something.
Right.
The girls all love you. Got it. And I'm popular with the gals, and everyone wants to be you, and the bucks are flying. Shut up. Same fucking shit.
Bring your club skills to your boss and say, hey, well, you passed me up for that promotion, but you know what I could do in the club?
Hey, watch it. At the club, I'm fucking great.
Right.
It's a celebration of life. They started
so
from nothing.
Stupid.
Yeah, of course. Oh, always money, big handfuls. No one in rap has a fucking credit card. Putting it on the charge card, paying it on time.
Yeah, oh.
Why don't you stop with the big handfuls of bills?
It's exciting. You start from nothing, and then you look around. Started from the bottom, and now we're here.
No, I understand that. But and I know rock songs have varied themes.
Yeah.
But there are a lot more themes than the same shit.
All they do is sing about the club. What about the hands up one? I tweeted about it. Only a few people got it because I guess they don't listen to pop music.
Which song?
The hands up like the ceiling
the
can't hold
song?
Us. Who gives a fuck?
That's the
You're
only time.
Celebrating.
It's the only time anyone told
Can
me
you play
I was
that
good.
Song?
Yeah,
this is dancing down at the disco. This is the one that's going to drive Jimmy nuts if you haven't heard the song before. They want you to put your hands up like the ceiling can't hold us. Like, who cares? What happens then?
You're living in the moment.
Listen to this one, Jimmy. This has a lot of the shit you're saying today.
Can we go back? This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like the ceiling can't hold us.
And everyone in the club puts their hands up.
What are you fighting for?
We're invincible in this moment.
I do like this, though.
See?
It's catchy, but the words are stupid. AIDS.
They could be singing about something else.
Why would they?
Children are hungry. They're not eating. There's life on their face. You know, I would enjoy that, too.
And then this shit.
So pretty much, Oak just wants instrumentals until the hook.
Yeah. Yeah, I like good hooks and I like beautiful voices.
There are adult contemporary radio stations.
I just want to know why it's cool to fucking put your hands up like the ceiling can't hold us.
Because we're living in the moment. And
then what happens
moment,
to those people when the club closes? Then they're on the street like every other dummy.
How about you sing a song, the club is all closing, we're going for eggs.
Right after the club. Yeah, where's the song about right after
exactly.
they leave the club?
Going to the diner.
Yeah.
Going to the diner.
Same thing and all. Raps, I was talking more about rap songs than clubs, because club songs are just mindless shit.
And this guy's still babbling. He could have done the hook there again.
Yeah. He's doing another hook at the end
all
of the
right,
verse.
Wayne, let's
Stop
go.
Stop singing about the beat. When's the last rock song that harped on the guitar? Listen to the drums. Never.
There have been lots of rock songs that scream out guitar before the guitar starts.
It's 1 second of it. It's not the entire, and they don't yell guitar. They yell guitar. And it's you know, again,
yeah, it's the same thing.
It's not the same thing because it doesn't permeate the entire song.
And there's lots of rock songs about partying and drinking
and love. And yeah, there are. But I'm saying the point of view in rap song is almost all the same. Mm. It is an alpha point of view, and it is the same fucking points. They don't do that in every rock song.
They're talking to Dummy again. Hold on a minute.
Listen, you got a chance to meet Maria, and you did the weather last
hour. Yes, I did.
And that's
learning
fitting.
Quickly.
That's fitting because Maria, she wants to go into TV.
No, it's great.
Possibly. Yes.
And also fitting because we're handing out blizzards.
They treat her like she's a kitten.
Yes. Blizzards.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh, good one.
Like a dumb little cute
so
thing.
There's blizzards there. Dairy Queen and Children's Miracle Network, which of course Miss America's involved.
They got blizzards right outside our building today.
I want to swim walk
right over
there.
And they got Miss America. There
and they're still on the table,
yeah,
still waiting for a slide across the table. Someone to take out the blizzards today, and then they're talking to Miss America, who Anthony pointed out that crown just makes you look dumb.
It looks, you look like an idiot with the crown on. You're not royalty,
yeah. Who are you, Christ?
Yeah,
you want to be crucified.
And then they talk to her like she's a little kid. And you did the weather.
The weather. And that's good because she wants to do TV.
Yeah.
Oh, she has
a great shot at us.
Yeah.
That's obvious.
Fuck.
Like the ceiling can't hold us.
Right.
Uh-huh, uh-huh,
but they're fighting. Uh-huh. There's a fight going on and there's a thing. And the ceiling can't hold these people because they're superstars.
See? There's a lot going on.
There's nothing going on. That's my point.
What's a good fucking hardcore rap song about the club?
Oh, God.
I mean, 50 Cent's In the Club is probably the quintessential.
That's the name of the, you know.
Club song.
Every one of those fucking songs is the
but they're
same
not. You
thing.
Don't even listen to rap.
Yo, I listen to
a
lot more rap than
Big
you think.
Big Daddy Kane, asshole.
Exactly.
Oh. I don't even know Big Daddy Kane, asshole. Was.
No, I don't listen to new rap, but I mean, I've listened
to
rap.
Well, because they used to rap about all sorts of shit, not just the club.
You like Kool Herc? Exactly.
They used to say a hippie.
Exactly.
Stop rocking.
That would be like me citing like
and watch
Motley
they play
Crue
basketball.
Exactly.
That's fair though.
Well, you should.
There's still bands that are still working.
That's right.
And Motley Crue,
those guys are true artists.
What are you talking about? Motley Crue and Poison didn't have the
same. You ever
same...
hear Girls, Girls, Girls?
Yes,
exactly. That's art.
No, but they didn't always sing about the same thing.
Well, neither do these
just
rap guys.
Just because you don't like girls, yeah, do. you don't appreciate a song about girls.
Exactly.
What you just said, the problem was they all, rap guys sing about girls.
They got
their
the
same,
money.
But rap guys come from the same...
What are some of the themes, Jimmy?
It's the same alpha male point of view. It's the same tone to all the guys. Like, they're all the same... At least in rock music, you have fucking different tones. You have the fucking the simp who's always in love, or you have
that's true.
But you know what I mean. You have different. You know, Sabbath sings about certain things, and Kiss. There's just a bit of a difference. Whereas in rap, they're all coming from the same point.
Yeah, but that's because it's your music. So you listen to full albums and you listen to all the songs. Whereas rap, you just get a taste of what's on the radio. So you're like, everything's the same.
Every other song is
but you know
about
that's
the club.
True,
and
they're all.
But it's true about
money.
Rock too.
Watch rap videos. Yeah. They're all fucking.
Watch rock videos.
Every rap video has a guy in it.
Yeah.
They always are flashing money. Rock guys aren't always flashing money. Look how much we made. All right, good.
Yep.
They're not always doing that.
Yeah, but the whole rock culture was that. It was cars, and it was girls, and it was drinking, and it was...
Yeah, but there's more of a variety in their topics and what they sing about. Rap is... It's the same as... Fucking, like, black guys who will not air certain dirty laundry in public. Like, black guys talk differently among themselves. That's why there's just it's a cultural thing where that scene is successful only. And, like, Eminem's the only guy that raps about being afraid. That's why I like him. He's the only guy in that whole fucking business who raps about being scared. None of them are scared.
He a pussy.
But you know what I'm saying? Like, none of them are fearful or none of them...
Yeah, but that's also...
Gotta look all hard.
Yeah.
I'm all hard.
That's what I mean.
But if you listen to as much rap as you've listened to rock, then you would have a different perspective on it.
Name me rap songs. Name me another rapper who talks about being afraid. And maybe there is another one, but name me another one that talks about being afraid.
I don't know.
I'm scared.
I mean, you listen to a lot.
Yeah, sure.
So name me another rapper or a rap song that kind of talks about fear or, like, you know, he talked about being fucking molested. Like, I'm not saying every rapper should do that, but he's, like, the only one doing it.
Then it put his dick in my ass.
Doing it anymore.
But you know what I'm saying?
Nobody's even listening to him.
Historically, he's the only one who did it.
Yeah.
Who else, but in all of that time, who else has been? That's what bugs me about.
Gangsta
like, I like
fag.
That gangsta fag was great, but they don't fucking.
But people, their audience doesn't want to hear it either. I mean, if they did, they wouldn't be selling records.
Well, that's true.
Maybe that's true.
What about Blurred? Maybe? What about the song of the summer, Blurred Lines?
Although
right?
Eminem is the biggest selling rapper in fucking history.
He's white.
That's huge.
But and also because he's good. There's, you know, fucking.
No, he's good. Yeah, I mean,
DJ Snow is a white rapper. He's not a seller. Vanilla Ice is a white rapper. He doesn't sell like.
No,
like
no, of course. I'm not saying Eminem's not.
And lyrically, he's great. And he's got Dr. Dre. I mean, he's a legit guy in that business. But he's more interesting to me because of what he talks about.
He can get away with more because he's white. It's the same reason he's never said the N-word in one song.
Not saying nigga is one thing, but he doesn't. What I don't like about Eminem is the only targets he goes after are weak ones. Like, he doesn't even make fun of black. Yeah, that's kind of corny. But, I mean... Come on, dude.
But he knows that, you know, he can get away with this. He can do more emotional stuff, and he can talk more about being scared. But he can't talk about being tough.
No, but he does. Sure he does. As long as his targets are white, he does.
I don't like that.
But he, of course he does. Like, he's trashed insane clown posse.
That's who he can trash.
He talks about being tough in a general sense. He just doesn't compare himself to black guys and say he's tough. And he doesn't, you know what I mean?
But those are his peers. Like, he can't compare himself to his peers. He's never done that.
Maybe I mean, not.
You know, as far as being ballsy goes, like he's like, okay, I'll do this instead of that.
But his subject matter is just more varied, and I don't think that other rappers couldn't do it if they're good. I think there are a lot of good rappers.
Oh boy!
But I think the thing that made Run DMC so fucking hot so fast was the fact they put guitar in their fucking rap. Like,
of course, yeah.
Like, just anything different. The themes, and I like rap. I'm not just shit. I like it, but it's the thematically, it's too fucking similar. All of it.
Oh, boy, you lose, Sam.
Oh, Sam.
Well, the tweet came in, so you lost. Sam was wrong. You guys are fucking nailing it. Fuck the club. There you go.
Oh, fuck the club.
It says that on Twitter?
That's it. You're done.
It's got to be true.
You are done.
And I don't know when to admit defeat, I guess.
I don't think their audience wouldn't like it if it was good. I really don't. I don't think rap audiences can't handle that stuff. I think they would. Oof. As long as the beats are good and fucking it's sung well. I mean, I think, you know?
Jay-Z's whole album is about cocaine deals.
Jay-Z has many topics that he sings
about.
A lot of songs are about the club.
Jay-Z's sung about the club. Jay-Z's sung about slinging crack. He's sung about missing a girl.
Annie.
About money.
He's sung about Little Orphan Annie. He's sung about having money. He's rapped about smoking weed. But he's made love songs.
And he got a New York City map and...
And
sung about every fucking square inch of it.
Some geographically based songs.
It's a hard knock life.
It's a great song. And that's the other thing. He's been putting out hits from 96 until 2013.
It's a fad.
Okay, go back. Because he's doing it again. He's insecure. Let the fucking little broad do her part. You hear him go,
It's a sped up track from a movie soundtrack.
But tell him to shut the fuck up and let her do her thing.
Listen, people don't want to hear that, though.
Because he's doing play-by-play. Let them do their thing. Go ahead, E-Rock. Listen for him doing play-by-play.
Take the bass line out. Let it bump, though.
He's feeling it. You can feel it, too. He's letting you know. Like, oh, shit, this is hot. Hope thinks it's hot.
From standing on the corners bopping to dropping some of the hottest cars New Yorkers ever seen. For dropping some of the hottest verses rappers ever heard. From the dope spot with the smoke blocks singing the murder scene. You know me well.
See, he's singing about going from slinging rock on the corner.
Yeah.
Page 3 of the lyrics.
Jesus.
He's singing about getting his life together.
Well, he's singing about, you know, getting that paper.
Right.
Let's have Roland read Jay-Z lyrics and watch his brain blow up.
Yeah, I'll get us till 10 o'clock. One song.
What about Blurred Lines?
It's a great song.
Yeah, but you got T.I. rapping over it, messing it all up.
Some people are saying that does.
Right?
Oh, I like it. Really? I like that, but.
I think it's too much sometimes, man. Give me Blurred Lines. This is the song of the summer.
Yeah, it is.
I know you want it.
It's Alan Thicke's son, Robert.
he come from, by the way?
Alan's boss.
He's been around for a while.
But who they even fucking knew Alan Thicke had a son?
A lot of people.
Yeah?
Yeah, he's been around a while now. He's kind of getting old, actually.
Yeah, he's like in his mid to late 30s.
I never knew he even had a son.
He had a few hits before this.
Your
he
son. Did.
Grandmaster Mel and the Furious Five. Huh?
We're not talking
about
that.
About different shit, though.
See, this is a cool song.
It's a great
and then
song.
T.I. comes in. I wasn't needed.
I think they're trying to appeal to hip-hop radio and pop
hey,
radio.
Hey, hey, hey. But hey, they double, got it. Hey, hey, hey.
Double their spins. I didn't think Pharrell was enough, I guess.
Where's T.I. coming soon, right?
Yeah.
The video's pretty good.
The one with the titties? Did you see the uncensored one?
Yes, we did.
Cool, pretty good.
It's a really cool song.
Great song.
And then T.I. comes in, and it just wasn't needed.
Yeah, I think sometimes they try to craft these songs for, you know what I mean? Because they're not, because you don't know when it's going to be a hit.
Yeah.
So they got to throw in a rap verse just in case.
Where is the rap verse?
It's coming either this verse or the next one. There he is.
When you bet that to go from Malibu to Paribu, yeah, you had a big machine bad in you. So hit me up when you're passing through. I give you something big enough to tell your to swag on them even when you drag casual. I mean, it's almost
like that. Nice. It's not bad, right? I'm looking at tits.
Yeah, I don't mind this.
Cute.
A lot of times I hate when rap comes into a song like this, but I don't mind this.
It fits, I think. But a lot of people are with me. Oh,
damn, that chick's naked.
I don't know.
Yeah. Wow.
The fucking tits are showing on TV.
Ripping off, what's his name there?
Simply
Father Palmer?
Oh, the ukulele. He's ripping off Tiny Tim.
Simply Irresistible with naked chicks.
Look at that fucking ass.
Yeah.
Jesus. Oh, of course, we gotta close the curtains. Where the fuck do we work?
We can't play the blurred lines video.
We're here in church.
Look, they're closing the curtains.
They're closing the curtains for the blurred lines video.
The uncensored one where they're completely naked.
Oh my God.
You know who Robin Thicke's wife is?
Who?
Paula Patton, who's in here.
Oh, she's fucking hot, man.
Yep. I am?
She's been with her for a really long time, like 20 years or something.
Wow.
It's a great song. They're calling this the summer song, right?
This is the song of summer.
It is, right?
Yeah. He really looks like his dad.
Yeah, he really
Jesus
does.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, my God! Did you see those
tits? That ridiculous?
I fucking just, I couldn't even contain myself. I had to yell.
Wow, that girl is amazing.
There's a new, while we're talking about rap and all that, there's a new song to add to your collection of songs that just use the N-word constantly. Yeah.
What's that?
It's called Fuck With Me, You Know I Got It.
Can we hear some Fuck With Me, You Know We Got It? What?
Yeah, Jay-Z featuring Rick Ross.
And
yeah?
I've been corrected, by the way. Somebody who reminded
corrected.
Me of a guy I should have remembered.
Who?
He's saying Tupac.
Yeah.
Okay. It's Bone Thugs a group or Bone? Are they
Bone Thugs
like
and Harmony
group?
KRS-One. I should have remembered KRS-One.
Of course,
I don't know. I'm not familiar with Mos Def or Kanan or Cypress. Like I don't know a lot of their music, but KRS-One I really like, so I should have thought of him.
Yeah. Fucking Blurred Lines video. That uncensored one is fucking.
That's ridiculous.
Got me all worked up.
Jesus.
Is this it?
Yeah, wait till the first verse comes in. You'll love it. Rick Ross's first verse.
I do like these. I like a good rap song
just
that drops
N-bombs
constantly.
Okay, then you'll like this.
All right. Mm-hmm.
But the N-word's bad, right? Remember, kids.
Remember, kids.
If you say it, you're done.
Right. But this is acceptable.
This is fine.
By the way, this is Rick Ross, who 50 Cent was not able to even come close to killing his career.
Yeah.
With 50 Cent?
Yeah, you couldn't.
No.
You couldn't touch him.
No, it's really weird. That did nothing to
her. It's too good.
When does this goddamn song start?
A little while.
How many N-words in this song?
A lot.
A lot.
Over under 100. What do you take?
It's under 100, but okay. Like Rick Ross's first verse is just rhyming the N-word with the N-word.
Oh. Sex bitch, I hope she got it. Uh-huh. Come fuck with me, you know I got it.
These songs songs are good for getting your ego up.
He sounds dangerous.
Is he really considered good? I guess he
Rick
is.
Ross, yeah, he's hot.
The curtains are still closed because we're here in the N-word?
That's right.
Oh, okay. I wasn't sure.
Yeah,
I wasn't
sure. They don't want to see four smiling faces.
All right.
I just landed in Europe, nigga.
One.
Shopping bags, I'm a tourist, nigga.
Nigga.
Money talk, I speak fluent, nigga. Reebok's on, I just do it, nigga.
The way he says it is great.
Look at me, I'm pure, nigga. I bet the hoes on my tour, nigga.
I love this.
I don't bop, I do the money dance.
You like Rick Ross?
Yeah.
My bitch whip cause $100,000. Red Birch, you see me slide. Sex bitch, I hope she bought it.
You're down. Bitch, I like it. You're liking it.
Fuck with me, you know I got it. Fuck with me, you know I got it.
See, Jay-Z's still putting out hits.
Yeah.
Still. Nobody else does that. Nobody.
No. No.
From 96 to 2013?
Yeah. Even though this is kind of enjoyable.
It's great.
It's just drivel.
It is drivel.
Fuck with me, I got it.
You know I got it.
It's just nonsense.
Fuck with me, you know I got it.
Nonsense.
Fuck with me, you know I got it.
You need that sentiment in your life sometimes, though.
Sometimes, yeah, but.
Coach landed in Rome, nigga.
Hope's about it, too.
Oh, hell sees us home, niggas.
Oh, hell sees us home, niggas.
That's Jay-Z?
That's Jay.
He hangs out with the president.
Why is he messing up everyone's song?
It's his song.
No, let the other guy do it. He was doing great.
Yeah, he hangs out with the president.
Yeah, but no, but this is why when people say outrage over the word nigger, this is why it's phony. I don't care why black guys say it or it's empowerment or it's ironic.
Blah, 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 blah.
It's the outrage is fucking
yes.
Fake.
It's phony.
Jay-Z can jump on the track and say a nigga got unlimited credit.
You think Obama has the conversation with him? Like, look, maybe you should set a better example there, Mr. Z?
No, because he doesn't care. He likes the
music. Of course not. Of course. Of
same
course.
As the same reason that fucking Paula Deen or Riley or Paula Deen's number one for saying it 30 years ago on front page. She said nigga 30 years ago, front page. ESPN guy called his coworker an Uncle Tom and a nigger. Called him a house nigger.
Yeah.
It's on page 19 of the Post, and it's not even in the fucking Daily News.
No,
and this is in front of people, and he said it angrily.
Right.
Where?
Exactly. How is it not front page?
No, I don't even know about this story.
In Florida, they were doing some speaking thing, and the one guy was drunk, and he calls up. I think ESPN will fire the guy.
Yeah.
But this is the press. This is why you call us paranoid, why we fucking have zero respect for people's language barriers and your fucking offense. This is why.
Yeah.
This is how because the press will cover it differently, and when the press covers it differently, corporations react differently.
React differently, absolutely. I was thinking the other night, the word, if white people use the word nigger, it's like, it's the new abracadabra. It's a magic word that makes your career, life, and everything disappear in one fucking word. I was just thinking how horrible that is. Like, one fucking magical word, and your shit goes away.
And then you're fired. You go in your car. You turn on the radio and have to listen to Rick Ross and Jay-Z.
Right.
Like, what?
It's insanity.
What did I say?
Right.
But that's what's going on. The fucking guy gets into an argument.
Oh, yeah.
Rick Ross
is happy about
fucking,
it.
He looks
he would fuck you up.
He's looking fucking man.
Tatted.
Oh, he's scary, man.
He looks like those cartoons from when I was a kid of the guy that would stir the fucking the white hunter in the big black pot.
He looks kind of
Jesus.
He's got a little Mr. T thing happening. A
little bit, right?
A little bit, right?
Wow, he's fat.
He doesn't give a fuck though. Come fuck with me,
He don't give a fuck.
He was drunk, and they were at a club or something in Florida, and the one guy was trying to stop the big drunk guy from embarrassing himself, Douglas. And Michael Smith, and he called him an Uncle Tom and a house nigger, and the hulking dog. This is in a club in front of people.
Yeah.
And again, I don't care that it happened. Two guys arguing, but it's page 19 because what white people say has more value. That's the press.
Right.
Yeah.
What white people say means more.
It
has more value because white people are smarter and better. And more adult and superior. So therefore, Paula Deen 30 years ago should be front page news. But this guy, It's what they do. So that's why you can't. That's the arrogance of the press.
Yes.
So white people, once again, make me sick to my stomach.
I am I'm amazed Sal is in here for some reason.
I would love to know why.
No, I was
Sal,
just to
comment?
He probably wants to jerk off looking at Rick Ross.
No. there actually is a lot of... Hip-hop's taking this like weird trend right now where... Oh. People are talking more about...
Don't swallow while you're making a point.
Sorry. There's a guy, his name is Kendrick Lamar. He actually does these concept albums. Like, no one in the hip-hop industry is doing concept albums.
Like and Tommy? Like a rock opera?
Yeah.
No.
I don't like his last name.
And he's pretty much one of the biggest rap stars in the...
What, Lamar?
Lamar.
Yeah.
All right.
And his album, Good Kid, Mad City, is a whole concept album from...
here's what's bothering everybody. Sal's probably right, and he probably does know what he's talking about, but he's forced this out before I'm ridiculed. Tempo is bothering everybody.
That's why I come plowing through. And it's a whole perspective from like a black stripper in Compton.
Can we hear some of this, Iraq?
So play Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe. That's the song.
Okay. Oh, Bitch that's Don't like, Kill My Vibe.
Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe.
Tyler, thank you.
How do you know his name?
Why wouldn't I? He's a good kid.
Oh.
That means you need Tyler to do something for you.
This jazzy guitar sound.
Yeah, he uses a lot of jazz samples.
Yeah?
That's why I actually really
this is
like
a big hip-hop hit.
Because hipsters love jazz, by the way.
Do they?
Kendrick, they don't really love it. They just love saying they love it.
Yeah. Jazz is boring.
And
you just described the hipster.
Yes.
They don't actually love that weird shit they do.
They just love to tell each other that they love it.
And Sal's in here because hipsters love Kendrick Lamar.
Oh, really?
He's good, too, but...
Hipsters. Is he seen as a smart black guy?
Yeah.
He's really young, too. He's like
he is good.
Oh, I know.
But it's not
he's
that
putting a wacky voice on.
He does crazy shit. They don't kill my vibe.
I don't like
trick,
his voice.
Trick don't kill my vibe.
He does have that sort of annoying cadence.
This is terrible. It's terrible.
Yeah, he's back to New York.
He might be creative, but I don't love his voice.
It's all over the place, kind of jazzy weirdness with that dumb voice he's putting on.
You don't like jazz samples?
I hate jazz. Jazz is so overrated as a music.
Yeah.
Four guys up on stage all playing different shit.
What about Miles Davis? E-Rock, this has to be the 10th time that we've done this bit.
Yeah.
What the fuck? What's the next line that is going to be said in this bit?
It's usually I just heard this in the bathroom, and then he got all mad.
That's true.
Okay.
I do hear it in the bathroom, and they get mad.
Usually it leads to Bob Dylan coming up.
I just go to Miles Davis, because that's the only one I like.
Of course.
Oh, God.
Some Kind of Blue, or whatever the fuck that album is
Coltrane,
called.
Coltrane, shut up. No one likes that.
Give me some Coltrane. Give me some Coltrane. You got Coltrane in there?
I'm looking.
Oh, God. Let me hear some Coltrane.
What?
People love saying they listen to Coltrane.
Yeah, it makes them sound smart.
Yes, they don't sit there listening to it.
No one listens to it?
No, you can't sing to it.
You got some Coltrane.
He's running a little slow.
Huh?
You don't know how to spell Coltrane.
Exactly.
C-O-L-T-R-A-N-E.
He's trying to find it on the L-I-R-R site.
Is there anything specific or...
Yeah, the one
it's
about...
all the same.
Exactly. How about anyone with that name on it?
Give us a couple titles.
There's a lot.
Yeah, I know a little Coltrane, though.
Let's see. There's Bye Bye Blackbird, Blue Train, All or Nothing, Alabama.
Alabama's a good song.
Alabama?
Yes.
Okay.
Jimmy doesn't
never know.
You beat me to the bit, by the way.
So far, it's all right.
There we go.
A little horn.
Wow, man. I just put this on, sit back, and smoke a doob.
These call them jazz cigarettes.
It's Mickey Spillane at a bar.
Mickey Spillane!
Yeah.
Smoking a cigarette.
Yeah.
A dame walks in.
Ah, dame walked in. What a set of stems on her. She walked over, said she had a problem.
Right. That's what this is.
I took a drink of whiskey. What?
Hold on, give it a second. I think the horn is good.
I'm waiting for the verse to kick in.
Still 6 minutes left.
Terrible.
Don't worry, if Jay-Z got a hold of this.
Yeah, somebody got
20 pages of lyrics.
Yeah.
Ah, oh,
Listen to that horn.
Listen to that horn.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
Play the horn in Queens.
Yeah.
Play the horn in Brooklyn.
Right.
Idaho potatoes.
Right. Heard you.
I'm gonna switch out of this. Somebody's got to speed this up and add a drum machine to it.
No one listens to this and likes it.
I like this.
There's still 5 minutes.
It's just a slow horn beat. Right.
Could you fast forward to the last minute of the song?
I liked it when it turned into Baker Street.
I'm going to see if this progresses. I'm with you. Jerry Rafferty. Now we're talking a great artist.
Okay, some horn.
I'm with you on that
it's
one.
Good. Right. It's a horn. It's singing. You can sing along with it.
Play some real jazz. These fellas want to hear you, Rock.
Baker Street. Yeah, that's a good song right there.
This
is the last minute.
This is not fucking anything!
We fast forward it, too. It's progressive.
Oh, now the drums.
They added a little bongo.
Miles Davis' Bitches Brew. Put on something.
This guy's testing out the heads on his drums. By the way, that's all he's doing.
You hear it? Sal? He goes, put on Miles Davis' Bitches Brew.
That's a good album. That's produced
hipster
by...
Hipster shit.
That's not hipster shit.
He's
that's
doing the hipster
fucking,
shit.
That plays an Urban Outfitters.
I'm getting mad. Right? I'm getting mad.
No, this is terrible. This
because
is bad
Because people
jazz.
Sit there and go, oh, Coltrane. My Coltrane albums. Oh. And there's always in a movie some chick like says
film.
Like, oh, I got my stack of Coltrane albums, and the guy's like, you're into Coltrane? Fuck that, because she's so cool.
I know you'd rather have her say choo choo train.
Yes, or she pulls a train.
Anything you can do with your own voice sucks.
Listen to the drums. Just listen. They're not doing anything with
this
song.
Brushes, you know.
So you're going out there and saying Coltrane sucks.
Sucks. Okay. Yes, Coltrane sucks.
Like, I don't get the difference. I think you're right. I don't understand the different style. This is a music that hits you or it doesn't. It just doesn't reach me at all.
A lot of this is
music
like,
is perfect for a lobby.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's lobby
an elevator,
shit.
A lobby.
The this opening is, credits
you know,
for a movie.
You know, boring places.
Yes.
Would you play this on the beach?
No.
Right?
What do you play on the beach?
What's happening in this song?
Nothing. You gotta listen to the wave.
A lot of this stuff is very musician-oriented, and they make it complicated for the sake of
it's
being oriented.
Self-serving
exactly.
drivel.
I agree.
This is musicians selfish. That is sitting there nodding to each other
like,
wow, that's cool, and has absolutely no value to an outside listener.
Right, no musical
None.
Backing.
It's terrible.
Coltrane
I
is looked at as one of the
stuff.
Great
Fuck
artists.
Him. It's awful.
Listen to that. He's influenced like a lot of different musicians.
Where did he go for a little while, by the way? The piano was playing.
He went, to,
he went
go?
To the bathroom.
He decided that was the spot. I'm not going to play on that part.
He went to do some H.
Yeah, these guys are mega into H back in the day.
A little H in the bathroom.
That is probably what it is. They're all on heroin, and then no one can hear each other. They're all stoned.
Yes. Yes.
Want to step it up a little bit here?
Sure.
Oh, yeah, here we go.
Yeah, tinkle in the old ivories.
What is different? What's different about this one?
Would you have known if
why would
last,
you have tracks on your albums?
If the
why
last
would you
song,
just have one fucking long song?
If the last song went into this song, you wouldn't be able
this
to know.
Call it "This Is Shit" by John Coltrane.
Yes, Coltrane stinks.
A 47-minute track. One track. You don't need to name tracks in jazz songs.
A lot of people think he's hugely important to musical history.
No.
You don't think so?
No.
Why is he important? You can't answer that question.
Just have an answer.
I
know the answer to it, but I'd like to hear what you think.
That he's influenced so many musicians. Is that the correct answer?
I have no idea, but that sounds good.
Sal, you're the Coltrane fan.
Well, exactly.
Why is he important to music?
What do your friends in Brooklyn say?
I prefer big jazz standards. I don't like
ski
masks
catcher mitts.
You got to say
Jesus. And listen to Coltrane.
Coltrane was around in the, I think, the 40s and the 50s, right?
I
don't
no
know for sure.
Idea.
So imagine this black dude from wherever.
You covered all your bases there, by the way.
You know.
40s and 50s.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah, it's like Iraq's movie.
Imagine a black dude. Okay.
Covers all the
so
decades.
He's a guy who's
that's
breaking.
How he starts off every time he masturbates.
Go ahead, Sal's right. He's breaking multiple barriers between music in general because jazz is the.
What barriers need to be broken?
Hey, don't make
just
it sound
play your
so
fucking
important.
Music.
He's really kicked down barriers. What? No one ever went.
Right.
Awful.
Right.
People were doing that way before Coltrane.
Yes.
So what barriers?
He was doing two things that people weren't doing. He was providing a new form of music, and he was black. That's
a new form of music.
Yeah, no one really.
Look, there were no black people before John Coltrane.
Look what I'm doing. No one else is doing this.
There's something called the blues.
I'm being black, which is a barrier, and I'm being
But you said the blues. Oh, you said the blues. The blues only became popular once everyone started being like, oh, well, that's where you got rock music from. No one really knew.
I prefer Fuck With Me, You Know I Got It.
You know what I mean? Like, no one understood the blues until people in rock side saying, hey, where'd you get influence? Oh, I was into the blues.
That is true.
No, blues wasn't on the radio, you know what I mean? It never was. It was people like Hendrix.
There was no radio when blues first started.
But well, when Hendrix first
Tom
said,
has
you know.
A great comment right here. Mm-hmm. Shut the fuck up, Sal.
that's not very helpful.
Look, I'm not defending this sort of jazz. I like jazz standards. I prefer like the Buddy Rich big band era, that sort of stuff.
Can we get some Buddy Rich?
Yeah, like Buddy Rich doing
E-Rock, A-Train, Sandal. Sounds like the drummer from The Wonders.
Yeah, Buddy Rich. I don't care how much he got.
Oh, Jesus.
What's a song?
I should have.
What song?
Anything by Buddy Rich.
Anything by Buddy Rich.
Anything.
Well, you brought it up. Give me a title.
Oh. We don't know. We're not Buddy Rich's nephew.
Not you.
Do his nephew got like he's probably done a version of A-Train. Take the A-Train.
The A-Train again. I love fucking doodling about trains.
About the train.
I like standards. I like jazz standards. The big song, Satin Doll.
Look for his version of Fuck With Me, You Know I Got It.
Satin Doll.
Fuck With Me, You Know I Got It.
Why do they sing about? Well, they don't sing.
This just goes on and on and on like this.
But it's something good for Neiman Marcus to play.
Yeah, exactly. You'd be looking through. Can I help you with that? Anything?
Yeah, you hear a lot of "Can I help you" when this music is being played.
Thank you.
instead of Jay-Z going, can I help you?
That's 20% off.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks. I wish I liked it. Like, I wish it reached me.
No, it's just I'm
glad.
The
song about
it.
A train.
No, the A-Train's not in here.
Is this a jazz standard?
Oh, Duke Ellington, Satin Doll. That's another one.
Duke Ellington.
It's not another good one.
You have to look it up on his phone.
How good could it be? Is that the cash register?
Count of Basie? Duke of Ellington?
I bet you. I will bet you $100.
Is this Coltrane?
No, this is Buddy Rich.
See?
Buddy Rich.
I think it's Duke Ellington. We got something here. Oh my God!
It's the same song!
That's what I'm getting
at. We just heard this!
Sal, I got $100. I'm going to have E-Rock pick five fucking jazz songs.
Oh.
I bet you can't name the artist.
Oof, that's a rough one.
Then you're not a fan!
I never said I was. I like jazz standards.
Play a rock song from the 70s. I'll tell you who fucking does it.
I'm not saying I'm a huge fan. I like the standards. That's the thing. Everyone's taken a form of it. Like, Buddy Rich played Satin Doll. Buddy Rich played A-Train. He played all
those
things.
You think he can name a Buddy Rich song?
He didn't compose originals. That's not what you really do in jazz. You kind of just you hack other people's shit, you know?
What? This is the same song we just heard.
This is now piano bar music.
When you hear this shit, you know you're somewhere stuffy.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And you can't let your hair
You know
down.
You're not about to get your ass eaten in a bathroom.
Do you have this in a...
Jimmy really knows how to fucking...
I need this in a 34 long.
Bring
Do you
it
have
home.
That?
Right.
Get away.
Edgar!
Can we take a break?
This feels like a chore.
Just like this song.
It's a chore.
Break is going nowhere.
Yeah.
This is Booty Rudge.
Booty Rudge. This is music for running errands.
Sal likes jazz, but he doesn't know why.
He doesn't like jazz.
No, he doesn't.
You don't like jazz.
He's a hipster.
Stop lying. Stop lying.
You don't need reasons to necessarily like music. You can just like it for the tonality or the mood.
This is a great speech at the end of Footloose.
Footloose. What are you, Edgar again?
Footloose. I won a dance contest. Apple fuzz!
Don't hurt your neck. You get so excited.
E-Rock's gonna play a song for Sal.
Tonight, so Johnny's guest star.
Doc Severson.
Yes, and Doc Severson.
See,
and the NBC Orchestra.
He even knew his music was shit because he dressed like a fucking wild man.
Yeah.
Just to get any kind of attention. Hey, E-Rock, play a song for Sal. We want to see if you could get it.
It's Rush.
YYZ.
YYZ.
What do you think, Sal? You're a big jazz guy.
Cool.
You're a big jazz guy.
I'm not a big jazz guy. I never said that. I have no. I legitimately have no idea.
It's a song.
It sounds like. This is probably like 60s or 70s.
The intro to a 1970s news telecast.
No, this is like from the fucking...
The Jerry Lewis telephone!
Let's go to the telephone!
Right. Jesus. Ed?
Yeah, it's definitely the closing credits of Mannix.
E-Rock, what do you got? What is it, E-Rock?
It's Buddy Rich.
You just mentioned Buddy Rich.
Is it a standard? This is not a standard, no. Oh. He only played drums
it's
for 60 fucking years.
It's from the best of Buddy Rich.
It's from the best of Buddy Rich.
It's the best of. So what?
It's
I don't know
best.
Every. Do you know every fucking Jay-Z song?
If you gave me, yeah. First of all, yes. And second of all, if you gave me the best of, I would sing every lyric.
But I never. I said I was a fan. I
you should at least know the best of.
I'll sing every lyric of this.
I hate this shit.
Yeah.
You do.
And, yes.
And.
Coltrane.
And someone finally had it and said, fuck this shit, I'm going to write fucking words
yeah,
now.
We need words.
Right.
Because the song means nothing without words.
Do you like when they play the trumpet with the plunger bottom?
But at least...
at least this is a beat that makes... Like, they're all doing the same thing. Like, they're all playing the same song.
Yeah.
So this isn't the kind of jazz I hate. I don't like this, but I don't hate it. The kind of jazz I hate is the shit you're talking about, where it's four different things, and I want to throw my radio out the fucking window.
This like, sounds more like the Austin Powers
this is at least coherent
sequence.
This is the big band era. This says like
Oh, what do you know about the big band?
Well, it's mainly Buddy Rich, Gene Krupa, those sort of guys.
All these names that just evoke fucking hatred.
Wait,
in
isn't he a great drummer though?
Whatever.
Yeah. He's considered.
Aren't they all great drummers?
Listen to Gene Krupa.
Neil Peart, great drummer. Neil Peart.
Yeah, he is.
How do you say it this week?
It's Peart. I've never said Peart.
Neil Peart.
Canadians fucking say.
You got to throw a little French in there. Peart.
Yes.
Yeah, Peart.
Gene Krupa.
Gene Krupa's a great drummer. Give me some Gene Krupa. Let's.
He'll pretty much do the exact same song as Buddy Rich.
It's the same
thing. It's the same thing.
Is this it, E-Rock?
No, I'm looking for it. Hang on.
See, being a drummer, too, you appreciate Buddy Rich because he'll just do a fucking five-minute drum solo.
They're all great drummers.
Oh, great. A five-minute drum solo. That's what you want to sit down to at a party when put on so everybody, all your guests can go, wow, this is great, a five-minute drum solo. And then back to more.
After Wipeout, who gives a fuck?
Right?
As far as drumming goes.
Wipeout.
After that, who gives a fuck about drumming? Give me another drum beat that people go, oh my God, stop everything. You got to hear this.
What is this?
This is Gene Krupa.
Ah. We are.
Where's the great drumming?
Our boys coming home from Europe.
Right.
This is big band.
Yeah.
Let's hear his drumming.
This is older than Buddy.
Yeah. This is Coney Island shit.
Ah, yeah.
Like Boardwalk Empire background.
Yeah, I feel like I'm in the fucking Brooklyn diner.
Yeah.
All right, let's try this. I'm about ready to see a horse jump off a diving board. Hear the rhythm roll. Oh, Christ.
Hear the steel pier.
Is this the Andrews Sisters?
It really is a kill. Stay tuned for Harry Houdini coming up next.
Right.
I found one with the drums here. Let's try this one.
Ah,
Boogie Woogie.
Support our boys with war bonds.
Boogie Woogie. I had a Boogie Woogie on my couch. I had to sell it. Got rid of that fucking couch.
There we go.
What?
Yeah. Wait, you just changed songs?
E-Rock just changed songs. No, it's the same song.
I think it's two different files, but it's the same song.
You just changed songs.
Follow that car.
Yes, that's what this is.
Calling all cars, calling all cars.
Here, I'll change songs again, see if you can tell.
Proceed to Bill's Bar and Grill. There seems to be a disturbance. Someone might have seen a Negro.
Gene Krupa inspired Peter Criss, I guess.
I'm sure he did, but I want to hear. I like Peter Criss, and I like the drum solo in 100,000 Years. I don't care for this. Did Gene Krupa sing Beth? Gene Krupa could shit in his hat.
Gene Krupa.
Actually, the song was called Audrey, and then I said,
"Oh yeah, yeah." Oh God, stupid Gene.
There's no real cool jazz, just the people who listen to it.
What is this song where he drums and I go, wow?
Calling all cars, be on the lookout for a Negro who might have eyeballed a white woman. It's a felony. And a very good morning to all of you out there and all the ships at sea. Flash from Hollywood, where Gable's buried.
Did you notice the change? He changed songs.
I did notice a little change that one? There. Okay.
We went from Rick Ross to this? What the hell's wrong with us?
I don't know. Somebody came in here and started talking about jazz.
I can talk rap, too. You want to talk rap?
No.
Chubsy Ubsy, I'm going to punch you in the nose. Oh, why is he on a bullhorn? Wait a minute. Hey, Spank.
Where's the good drumming?
This one is lackluster.
How do you know this one's lackluster?
There's nothing going on in this one.
How about we look on YouTube for Gene Krupa?
Oh, dude, do Gene Krupa sing, sing, sing. That's
sing, sing, sing. That's so good. He was in jail.
Not in here.
that's another huge standard. Oh, big drum solo.
Not huge.
Everyone knows sing. You'll know this one, Ann.
I will not.
Oh, you will know this one.
Sing, sing, sing.
Yeah.
This is the one we know?
Gene Krupa.
Hold on.
Sing, sing, sing.
Gene Krupa.
I don't have Gene.
Sam has it.
All right, let's go
Turn
to Sam.
Turn that down, E-Rock, before I kiss your lips.
Oh, God, look at him. What a heroin addict. Oh, I know this one.
Yeah,
this one's been used.
Beast on drums.
Is he?
This one's been used in a lot of movies.
Chips Ahoy commercial.
What? Chips
Ahoy commercial.
What's that?
Oh.
Don't worry, ladies and gentlemen. Those trains are high tension steel.
Dun, 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 dun. Look at him go. They did so much heroin.
Yeah. I don't like the way jazz guys hold their drums like a fucking 6-year-old.
Look at this tiny little kid he's got. He's waving his sticks in the air like he just don't care.
This is all Looney Tunes music.
They're all just like ice cream men. Oh. I play the licorice stick. That's what they call the
I'm sure he's
clarinet.
Fine. So far, Tommy Lee kills him.
Yeah. Yeah, what? I don't see him spinning upside down either.
Exactly.
Put him on a fucking rig where he spins upside down and goes over the audience.
Imagine if you suggested that back then.
Wow, y'all crazy. Now you're talking loony.
I hate the way jazz drummers hold their sticks. It seems so uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Very traditional.
Very technical.
Why?
It's
traditional.
It's put the snare drum closer to you so you can get it. Oh. You can turn the stick sideways.
Is that Benny Goodman?
That is Benny Goodman.
It is. He's got the round glasses on. Benny Goodman died in a plane crash.
Really?
Yeah. I think they say the Germans shot him down or some shit. I don't know.
Mm. And then the Beatles come to America and say... Beat it, stupid.
Enough of this guy.
Enough, and that was it.
Whoa, they all stand up. It's like the beginning of fucking Indiana Jones and Temple of Doom.
Might as well be Pip farting on a snare drum.
Yeah, he's a good drummer. I just don't see it as being anything amazing. I'm sorry, Jimmy. That's fine, yeah, but I want to see something where I think, oh my God, he's amazing.
That's going to be good for cool. 1937, yeah. I guess.
Mickey D is better than him.
Yeah, what were you doing in 1937?
Right, exactly.
Huh? That was all right, I guess.
It's good for when they only had propeller airplanes, you know.
It's not as good as Lauryn Hill, but...
No.
That's the trick.
One time. Or Neil Peart.
Two time. Neil Peart. Fucking all of a sudden, out of nowhere, people deciding to tell us how to say Neil Peart.
No, it's Neil Peart.
No, it's Neil Peart.
Peart.
Shut the fuck up.
Peart.
There's a video here of Neil doing a tribute to Buddy.
Oh, really?
Let's see that video. Neil Peart's great, though.
It's Peart.
Phenomenal.
Peart.
You really want to see that?
Yes, I do. More than I want to do anything right now.
Oh.
Oh.
Sam wants more rap music.
Yeah, exactly. So don't worry, I'm sure he'll sing about the club.
Buddy Rich versus Neil Peart.
Well, that's not fair.
Really?
Oh, someone edited the video together.
Buddy Rich.
But you can see he can play the fucking drums. I mean, I don't know how they hold it upside down. It seems so counterproductive.
He's using his middle finger there to
Yeah, this guy's is a weird.
This is so. This was at a concert. This is the part you get up and get a beer.
I know you won't want to hear what I have to say right now, but I will tell you the drum solos I've enjoyed the most in the last ever concerts.
Yeah.
Tommy Clefetos, who's playing for Sabbath right now.
Oh, really?
People go fucking nuts after the solos.
Of course they do.
But I mean, normally people don't. They don't go to the bathroom. Yeah. I love
No, he used to play with.
Yeah, of course.
Rob Zombie. I like the snare drum cover Buddy Rich wears on his head as a hair. That's,
isn't
that a snare
that?
Drum cover?
Jesus. Where's the Neil Pierre?
He looks like Bela Lugosi at the end. It's fucking...
Hold on. Neil Pierre.
It's fucking Leonard Nimoy.
He's a fucking... My favorite drummer ever.
Yeah, he's phenomenal. I mean, you can't say he's not. He's
yeah, he sucks.
All right.
Don't say that,
Neil Pierre. We get it.
Big fucking deal.
I remember Bill Burr didn't like him.
Who cares?
We get it. Who cares?
He plays the drums. Big whoop.
Who cares?
Why are people cheering?
This is a benefit. Something for Buddy Rich's family or whatever like that.
Is he playing the same one?
I don't know. Playing a similar kit. But imagine like the top drummers in the world all of a sudden coming in.
Boring. Keith Moon, Bob O'Reilly.
I like Keith Moon.
Fucking drumming.
Keith Moon is fucking
like that.
Put a single out without any other people. It's some instruments, a singer, right?
I don't mind this.
What the fuck is it? What are we watching anyway?
It's
some dick playing drums.
We don't go to break.
Fucking Neil a dick.
He is. Look at him.
Where's Stalker Patty to come out and sing?
He's drumming in a turtleneck.
That is uncomfortable.
He's a dick.
Yeah.
That's true.
You know what?
Yeah, I've had it.
Good.
There you go.
Thank you, Opie.
There
God
you go.
Damn. Exhausted.
God, we could have done that 20 minutes ago.
That dude from No Doubt, he drums like naked with a mohawk. That's cool.
Who do they say is better, Neil?
That guy. We get right. it.
Listen, before we go to break, we got to make sure people know that podcast number 13.
Yeah, it's a good one this week.
The Opie and Anthony podcast. We're up to the 13th episode. This week, it's a couple of the people from Breaking Bad.
Yeah,
they gave us great interviews, Dean Norris and Betsy Brent.
Together, very rare to have both people together. That's Hank and Marie.
They were great.
On air, husband and wife.
And because you asked for it, we also put on the suck cock for K-Rock bit.
Of course.
And we put on Master Poe's hurricane evacuation plan.
Yeah, Monday we had a Master Poe retrospective.
We really did.
It was nice. Perfect.
It was great.
So he grabbed Master Poe's hurricane evacuation plan. That's a great bit.
And Master Poe gave us a little help with this week's nugget.
Oh, yeah. Opie and Anthony's nugget. going strong. It's going strong.
Wait
till the nugget t-shirts come out.
Oh, no.
You thought the wow sticker was big. Wait till our nugget stickers start popping
up. You guys got any nugget stickers? I need a signed nugget sticker.
Coming soon, a podcast of nuggets.
Oh. Just the nuggets.
Just the nuggets.
Why not, man? If Dunkin' Donuts could fucking just, sell the holes. We could sell the nuggets.
O&A, just the nuggets.
Just the nuggets is going to be the name of the podcast.
I'm going to go take a piss. I hope some Coltrane is playing in the bathroom.
No, it's going to be some dumb Elvis Presley interview.
You think that's it?
I once saw him drive by in his Cadillac.
It is a very... It's a pretty eclectic mix in that bathroom. You go in there one day and you're hearing fucking hit radio, hit music, and then you go in there and,
Well, Elvis Presley, that channel has just run out of stories. Oh my God.
I've had a few.
I almost saw him one day, and they do 30 minutes on that.
You know what I'm talking about.
Our exclusive interview.
Yeah, they really have nothing to say anymore.
They have nothing. It's all been said. So now they're like just digging way too deep.
Yeah, but Elvis's third pool guy will be interviewed.
Right.
Well, the king lacks chlorine. A lot of chlorine. In the...
My mama almost went out with Elvis Presley.
Ooh, exclusive.
Well, did she ever meet him? Well, no, not really. But she was at the concert in 1974.
But if they start talking about anything besides somewhat Elvis stories, listeners start... I thought this was an Elvis channel. What are you guys talking about?
Yeah.
They've run out of stuff.
I love their Elvis.
Because they got a guy there. He's just trying. He's trying hard, though. He's working hard, trying to find new Elvis stuff.
Live from Graceland, as if it makes a difference.
Oh, it's a bust.
Just say you're there.
Ooh, they're from Graceland.
Yeah. Well, the line is forming here.
Like, haven't they learned from, like, the Pearl Jam channel or whatever that you can just play Elvis?
Right.
Like, you don't have to tell stories.
Pearl Jam's getting a little old, too.
No, it's not.
A little bit. No. A little bit. About? I love the Pearl Jam channel, but it's getting a little old.
Great. Play the 90s channel sometimes in the bathroom. I heard Aini Kamosi the other day. Hot Stepper? You don't remember that song?
Still Loving Like That?
Yeah.
Let's play it into break.
Oh, it's a sick song, dude. Great.
Let's play it into break. Fuck it. All right, we'll be back. Wasn't it?
That's the title, but that's not the right song.
Oh, E-Rock.
Are you covering your ass?
What happened?
What, you spill fucking honey on the keyboard or something?
No, it says in a hunk of shit. Jesus.
Do I know this song?
Yeah, you were.
This is a big song, and this was his only song.
Play the right song.
I'm looking for it.
Fucking asshole.
Oh, here comes the hot stepper.
Of course.
Yeah.
I mean, I need composing songs.
Oh, yeah, of course. We'll be back.
No.
Here comes the hot stepper. I'm the lyrical gangster. Big up the crew in the area.
All right, we're back, finally, with the Opie and Anthony Show, and everyone's in their proper place. Me and Anthony are in the studio. He rocks behind the board, and Jimmy's in a stall somewhere.
Ah.
Perfect. The world is perfect.
Cock. Yeah.
You know, you go in the bathroom, and then you kind of look around to see who else is in there before you start talking shit about people that work here.
Sure, you got to.
So I'm in a stall, and Jimmy's at a urinal, and he actually says to me, "Hey, are you alone?" I'm like, "What do you think?" He goes, "Are you alone?" Because he wanted to say something.
Yeah.
I'm like, "Yeah, I'm alone in the stall, you idiot."
Thinking you're bringing someone in there with you?
Yes.
Yeah. Who's in there with you?
But he actually, I think he's just conditioned.
Yes.
Hey, are you alone in there? Yes.
Tapping his foot on the floor with the wide stance when he sits.
He was at the urinal.
Oh.
I was telling him about how. You were at the urinal, and I'm in a stall, and, you know, you want to, you know, talk some business.
Yeah.
Or sometimes we just like talking shit in there. And you actually asked me if I was alone in the stall.
Yeah,
I meant in the room.
I was like, "Oh, it's just you, right?" Like I was saying, not knowing else in the bathroom, but it sounded like I was saying, "Are you in there with someone?" It's fucking freezing in here, by the way.
Yeah, that's why I didn't take off my pajama top yet. Mm-hmm. I came in with my pajamas today.
Is that your pajamas?
Yeah, I ran out of clothes today.
How can you wear pajamas? I can't do it. I'm a naked sleep guy.
Well, the breeze off the ocean was.
You wear top and bottom pajamas?
Some days I just can't wear my underpants.
Insane.
If you roll over in your sleep, a lot will get twisted around your fucking.
Some days.
Sleeve holes by your neck and.
Getting a nice breeze off the ocean.
Yeah.
Yeah. I ran out of clothes though. I got like smelly sweats on again. First time for the smelly sweats in honor of Troy Kwan.
Oh, boy.
He was the one that forced me to start dressing better. All right, so Anthony Weiner, we're loving this guy again because he doesn't give a shit. He has nothing to lose, and he went at it with George McDonald. Is he running for the...
Yeah. No, he's got a farm.
I don't even know.
Take us out.
No. See, Sal, that's how that works.
That was hilarious.
And for the record, Sal's not behind the board. No. He does not get credit for
that. Yeah, we should take a longer break.
For that comedic timing.
That was funny. How much time do we got?
What? What's the matter, Chippa?
That's why. How much time we got before we come back?
We're back.
We're not on break.
He went to break.
No, it was a joke.
He didn't do it right?
It was just a joke. Chippa, you're a dummy.
You know what CNN is focusing a lot of time on today?
Not the ESPN guys.
No, because they're talking about how the Ferris Bueller house is for sale.
Oh, I just want to see the guy sitting in the same seat I sat in. There we go. All right.
Oh, the president on Leno.
Yeah.
Wow, you almost got to meet. You would have got a picture with the president finally.
Oh, man.
There are people who are on staff there who are not getting a picture with the president.
That's
true. Really?
No. He's when I was there, Secret
Service. You were in the same seat. He's got to sit on your farts.
Yeah.
Obama.
Secret Service was there when I was there.
And they had
not very secret
blue curtains up.
They needed the money.
Oh, but they had big blue curtains
really good
up.
Point.
And you could see where like Sorry. They rope everything off when he's in. Like yeah. even the hallways are curtained off, so you can't take a shot down the hall. Like they are fucking.
Wow.
Secret Service thinks of everything, dude. Mm. So even in NBC, like they said he probably walked in, went right to his dressing room. He gets walked right out, and. Roberta, the stage manager, who's like the only one who gets to walk with him and Bush. They like her for some reason. Wow. Like, she gets to walk them down.
That's got to be a lot of lonely walks.
Yeah.
Because I was in a hotel with George W. in Arizona. Went out there for a radio conference.
George it up, Debbie.
Eric Logan and then Fareed invited me to speak in front of a bunch of broadcasters.
Right.
And then I decided to stay because I had no life because we were fired.
Did Fareed pay you for it? $100,000?
Wow. I did take him for a few bucks because I stayed at that resort a few extra days and just said it's on
stayed a year.
Citadel.
Yeah.
It was Citadel, I think.
Oh, goody.
And, George Bush was staying at the hotel, and just like Jimmy said, they fucking curtain off everything right up from where he enters the hotel through the lobby. It's this, like, weird tunnel thing.
Yeah, they don't want you to be
And it's all about, so, yeah, you could, if you're like a, God forbid, person that might do some harm.
Yeah.
Hey, you might want to maybe guess where he is in that whole network of tunnels.
Right,
but you can't see him.
Yep.
That's a hell of a tie Obama has on. That is a nice ass tie.
You like that?
Why? Yeah. Just nice.
Why? You want to hang yourself with it?
I would love to. The presidential tie, I'd wear it first.
But
what is he doing on Leno, by the way?
Like, they all. I don't want to tell you who I'm on with when I go back to 26 for my bit.
Oh. Michelle Obama?
No, they wouldn't put me on with an Obama.
Why?
They just wouldn't. And
That'd
it's
be
a,
funny.
It's a bit that I'm tossing to anyway. Like I'm tossing to.
Is it a politician?
Yes.
Oh. Is it Bill Clinton?
No, I wish. No president.
John McCain.
John McCain.
I'm good.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah. I've never met him.
You guessed it.
I'm good.
He requested me.
So Anthony Weiner.
It's torture.
There you go.
Anthony Weiner on the campaign trail, and George McDonald and him went at it.
Yeah, Vaughn. All right.
Fuck yeah. E-I-E-I-O. You ever get caught in a loop and not forget the old part? You keep going E-I-E-I-E-I-E-I. And your money goes, chip it, stop it. Lamar can't keep it up. E-I-E-I.
Lamar.
So they're on the campaign trail, I guess, and there was a confrontation.
Yeah. Anthony Weiner has a newfound freedom. He doesn't seem to give a shit now.
Mm-hmm.
He's still running for mayor. He's out there. He's campaigning. But he's not taking any guff from anybody, is he?
No. And I guess McDonald got angry after Weiner approached to greet him and touched his chest.
Ooh, yeah, like it was like an aggressive, tap on the chest.
Wow. Hey. Okay.
And they were all like on stage.
He just didn't want any of Wiener's cum on him.
His jacking hand.
Right.
But New York One, I think it was New York One, had the mics.
Who were they playing?
Yeah, was it a close game or something? I just wanted to tag your joke.
They had the mics queued up already.
How about the Bills, the Teds, the Franks, the Arnolds, and the Steves?
Microphones. And so
they queued up. Why don't they R them up?
Exactly. And what if they're uglied up? Why'd they queue them up?
And so they caught the confrontation on mic.
Okay.
And recording.
Here we go.
I heard what you
don't
said.
Put your hand.
Really?
What's going to happen if I do
it?
It's up guy now.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Is she?
Okay.
I don't have it. What did you do, Grandpa?
Ooh, okay.
Wow. I love the what's going to happen if I do.
Yeah, but
it's the same shit.
He goes, you have an anger problem. He goes, no, I don't. He goes, yes, you do, Grandpa.
Yeah, that was Anthony Weiner going, wait, tough guy now? Tough guy?
At an AARP event, yes. Which is for old people.
Right.
He fucking calls him Grandpa.
That's not going to help him.
No, that won't old help. People. That won't help, thank you.
It's not good.
Yeah. I'm going to go see the Queers tomorrow.
Yeah. What are you, sitting on a fist chair?
Yeah, he best...
Yeah, it was hard to hear, so he said, I said, keep your hands to yourself. Don't put your hands on me again. And then Wiener said, what's going to happen if I do? And then says, you have anger issues. And then the McDonald guy goes, I don't have any anger issues. And then Wiener said, yes, you do, Grandpa.
Yes, you do, okay. Grandpa. Yeah.
And you got a big restaurant, too, old Mr. McDonald.
Oh, all right with the McDonald's joke.
McDonald's. Get it.
Who's going to win this thing? Who the fuck's going to win this thing?
I don't know.
Probably but... Christina Quinn.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
She's the only one who hasn't fucking, who hasn't either sent a picture of her fucking genitals or paid someone to lick them.
That's all it takes.
She
to
wins
win it.
By default.
Right.
I don't send out cunt pictures or pay to fuck people. Winner.
Where do I check for the big win?
Yeah, the
what
big
about
win.
That cat guy that's. You can't
oh,
even
Williams?
Say
it. He ain't running. He's no. too crazy. He's a comedian. Who, oh. Cat Stevens? He's too busy fucking singing.
No.
He's in a wild world of whatever. Okay.
Oh,
no.
Oh.
The, who, the cat man, Peter Criss? He's playing the
no.
fucking drums.
Oh. There's a candidate whose name is really long and confusing, but it starts with C-A-T, so it's just been like the campaign is just like cat.
Oh, Katmandu.
No, it's not Katmandu.
Catch me if you can. Cat A Kism.
I'm tired. Are you?
Yeah.
Oh my God. Oh, what is this?
Apologize.
Yeah, I'm exhausted.
Travis is marching down the hall again.
Oh, good. Hope he's resigning.
Everything we don't know, he has
exactly.
To, everything we don't know, he has to come in and tell
us. I hope they find a lump he's got to tell us about.
Travis, do you love that you have to march down the hall to tell us stuff we don't know?
Yes.
No, like basic knowledge.
Yeah, well, you know, that's what I'm here for.
What happened?
No, I was going to ask, you guys are talking about all the mayoral candidates. Did you see the video where they all told a joke?
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Was I would love to see that.
Yeah, the Daily News got them all, well, all except one, to tell a joke.
I'm going to guess Spitzer didn't tell a joke.
Well, he's not running for mayor. So you
he's running for that right. comptroller.
Exactly.
It's almost like control, but it's comptroller.
I know, you don't need one guy to control all the free tickets given out.
that's a real position.
Comp.
What a horrible gig.
Comptroller.
Comptroller.
I think someone is going to really like the jokes.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Oh, no, of course he is.
All right, let's hear this. So
oh,
you got the
God, no.
mayoral candidates telling
I can't
jokes.
See.
Telling joke.
Candidate jokes.
Who's this?
I was in one of our stores this morning.
Hold on. Who is that? We got to tell who.
That's Katz.
John,
that's the guy.
Oh.
That's Mattis.
John Katz.
What's it called?
They call him.
Here, go backwards. I didn't hear his opening.
Apartment. And there's two melons.
Oh, no. Thank you. Put Velcro on the ceiling.
I was in one of our stores this morning. I go over to the produce department, and there's two melons talking. One says to the other, can't elope.
That fucking sucked.
Oh, shit.
That
wasn't
even
it? A joke.
Cantaloupe?
But
oh, like a marriage or something. All right, that's pretty fucking good.
But did he even set it up with marriage or anything?
I don't
no,
think
he didn't.
So.
He's a fucking egg-headed lump.
He said, you go into a store, there's two... Melons, and one says cantaloupe. That doesn't make any sense.
It's probably something like, why aren't you married? And the one melon said, because we're homosexuals.
Ah, right.
So we're not criminals, you asshole.
Yeah, right. Exactly, we're melons. For the same reason, fucking... we come apart like we're in Dealey Plaza in 1962. Whatever year it was.
Whatever year it was.
All right, that was a good joke. Do they get better?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Then I'm going out into the street. It's raining. There's slush all over the place. And there's
who is this? That's terrible to say there's sluts.
No.
He's crass.
No, he said slush.
He's dirty.
He said slush, like ice.
Dirty. He's not dirty.
By the way, my apologies. My characters are ruining the show today.
No, they're not.
I'm very sorry. I have humble apologies to anybody with two things on the sides of their heads that pick up sound.
Ha, 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 ha.
like.
All right, come on. Let's get to the slush joke by the same.
Yeah, here.
Slush.
So I have to.
Turned out it was George Harrison shaking his head no.
Hush all over the place, and there's two white horses coming. Oh, brilliant joke. So I have to make a representation. Two beautiful white horses coming down the street.
And then these fucking black horses looked at him, and I had him arrested. All
right. Into a bunch of.
Oh my God.
And they slip and they fall.
The horses fall.
Into a bunch of mud. That was my dirty joke.
That was his what? Dirty
oh,
joke.
A dirty joke. Wow, he's bad.
What happened?
It's terrible.
The white horses fell into mud. That's my dirty joke.
But it has to be.
Those are awful.
I think that's like, just a dirty statement.
Like, that's not even fucking close to being a joke or funny.
I hope that man has a heart attack.
It's only the first one.
All right.
How many more do we have to sit through?
Those are terrible.
Like 12?
Okay. All candidates.
Oh, my. All right, let's go to the next one.
Except one.
How long does it take Mike Bloomberg to screw in a light bulb?
How long?
3 turns.
Very good.
It's not bad.
All right.
Would have been funnier if he said, it depends on how many people are opening his asshole for him. See, because he puts it in his ass.
He puts it in his ass. Yes.
And it's one of those long fluorescent ones. He has it pounded in and then broken off on purpose. Oh. He likes a long fluorescent light bulb put all the way up into his anus, and then he wants his hips kicked so it shatters. I like to pass gas and have the glass hurt me.
Mein Heine.
What was Mein Heine?
Mein Heine?
Can we play one of those to break
oh,
you rock?
This is so bad.
All right, thumbs up. Good. Let's go to the next joke.
I like that the inventor and Epstein have found their audience finally.
Yes,
finally.
They have.
Which ones? You're not going to do it ever?
I'm not going to ever tell a joke? No, I'm not a very jovial guy.
Aww. Was that Wiener?
Yeah.
Yes, it was.
Not a very jovial guy. Ugh. Yeah, he's all serious when he's jacking off to some fat pig.
She's a delightful young lady. Yeah. I will not have her name sullied.
Fuck.
Love to.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I will say that he should have told a joke.
Yeah.
Well, maybe not.
Maybe not, yeah.
Because his jokes are pretty bad.
They would have been twisted.
Let's go.
It would have been some awful joke.
It would have been really good.
Love it.
Yeah. How do you get a homosexual to have sex with a woman? Yeah, fella, cunt full of shit. Could you imagine if he said that and then put his hands out like, huh?
Oh, God.
I swear to you, I've never heard that joke before.
Oh, yeah, that's an old
I've
old one.
I've never heard that one before.
That's what Cream Pie Jones did in the Duty Hat video at the end. He went,
Have we played the shit video in a while?
No, I don't think we have. Hmm. It's been a little too long. Maybe after the jokes?
Maybe. We'll see. Okay. See where we go.
So a mushroom walks into a bar, and the bartender says, hey, we don't serve your kind around here. And the mushroom says, why not?
But I'm not a...
I'm a fun guy.
I'm a fun guy.
It's laughing over you.
Of course.
Okay.
Oh, like it's because it's a fungus?
Yeah, fun
That's
guy.
My mother loves wordplay, Uma.
Stop talking about your mom.
Why? She's a marvelous woman with a wonderful fit. She has a problem with her ankles.
Why?
They're very swollen.
Why is that?
I don't know. They're like tomato cans.
Oh, supporting a lot of weight?
Grabbing them all the time.
She's Rubenesque.
Oof.
She has gout. She said sometimes Lamar grabs her ankles and she screams. Because the gout is acid attacking the joints, she told me. Chipper, rub my ankles with salts.
Yeah.
Warm salve.
Is that what the gout is?
Yeah.
Acid?
Yep. It's your body's not the ability to break down a certain type of acid. So it attacks one. And Judah was telling me about it. And he said it's like, he's like, if you just tap it, it's agonizing.
Really?
And then he was also talking about something else.
I don't want that.
Dropping the checks.
No, you didn't mention that.
I gotta go back. We're sitting in Montreal. I didn't know. I wasn't sure if it was a bit or not. I didn't know.
It wasn't a bit.
Oh, no.
I know. That's what makes it creepy.
Prostatitis or something. Or kidney stones.
Kidney stones.
And both of those things are apparently a salt issue. And we were sitting there with Colin. So he's talking about that and gout. And Colin goes, oh, apparently a big salt intake. You're a regular Lot's wife. It made me laugh so hard because I'm like, there's one salt person in history, and he grabbed them at 1 in the morning.
That was very impressive.
Funny. Yeah.
More jokes from the candidates for the...
Oh, yeah, these are great.
For mayor of New York.
Hi, I have two jokes.
Oh, Jesus.
Did you hear about the lady that walked into Christini's, walked to the back to the butcher's?
Oh, I know that one.
Yeah?
Yeah, she fell down and there was eggplants in her pussy.
No, there wasn't.
I believe this is the guy that owns the supermarket chain.
Christini's?
That's why he said Christini's?
Or
he owns the other one?
He used to run the MTA.
Oh, is that him?
Yeah.
That's a good channel, but they don't do music videos no more. MTV.
It's not even wordplay. It doesn't make any sense. It's just the same two letters.
It's just... I got a shit.
And the butcher said, lady, you got to go across the street to D'Agostino's. The second joke is, did you hear about the mushroom that walked into a bar?
Pause! The mushroom's like, why don't you serve me? What am I, fungus or something?
No, that's the joke.
No, Chip.
Why don't you serve me? Because I look like the Elephant Man's back, neck, face, and head.
He told the same joke.
Yeah, I'm fucking zooted from mushrooms. That's a joke I would have told.
Yeah.
Yeah. I ate mushrooms. I got so fucked up, I knocked an old lady's teeth out with a hammer claw. What? It's a true story. I was at a Halloween party. My friend's grandmother walked in.
Yeah, you fucking knocked your teeth out.
Yeah, I picked up a hammer. I'm like, there's a fucking monster here. But it was just her. She was real old. They had to put her teeth in a flowered hat and take her to the hospital.
Bartender says, we don't serve mushrooms here. And the mushroom goes, why? I'm a fungi.
Should end like Art Budweiser's press conference.
The difference between Fenway hot dogs are and Yankee Stadium hot dogs.
I know what it is. She don't like nothing that shape.
That is, yes. That's our lesbian candidate for mayor.
She don't like hot dogs. She goes, you know what the difference between a Fenway hot dog and a Yankee Stadium hot dog? Nothing. I step on them both while booing.
You can get Yankee Stadium hot dogs in October.
Yeah, not this season.
What are you talking about? Yeah. Yeah,
plus they won. That's,
yeah, they just won.
Stop doing 2002 baseball jokes. Yeah, what are you going to do, a dead ball era joke? Carl Yastrzemski reference, you dead fucking ball. Old lady.
Shut up. What was that, like 1910
or something? It was the 60s. It was like 68, 69. When the highest average, I think, was 301 Yastrzemski.
Dead ball era jokes.
Yeah, big. Talk about
terrible.
Oh, it's terrible. Yeah.
Oh God, that's funny.
Yeah. What do you get when you cross this? I don't know, but Chris Chambliss would fuck it. It's great. Fucking idiot. Stop doing sports jokes. Talk about girls indoor soccer like you should. You don't know baseball.
Fuck.
So my joke
is this John Liu?
Yeah. Oh, John Liu.
Great.
Lands at JFK Airport. And it's been a long flight. He's restless. He gets into his limo, but he says he wants to drive. So he gets in the driver's seat. The driver gets in the back. And he's cruising along.
Tooth hurty.
And then he gets pulled over by a cop. The cop comes up to the window. He looks in the back seat. Then he looks at the Pope. And he freezes. He turns white. He goes back to his patrol car. And says, he calls up his sergeant, says, Sarge, I don't know what to do. I just stopped somebody really, really important. And the sergeant says, well, everybody's got to obey the law. Give him a ticket. And the cop says,
oh my God.
Yeah, but Sarge, this is someone really
important. Okay, we get it.
And his sergeant says, well, who is it, the mayor? And the cop says, no, somebody far more important than the mayor. The governor? No, even more important than the governor. And the sergeant says, well, who is it? And the cop says,
face.
I don't know his name, but he's got the Pope driving him around.
So to speak, literally.
Well, no shit.
That's funny. I'm funny.
Why don't you do an Asian joke? He tries to get everybody fired for it.
Yeah, John exactly. Lowe. You can't tell jokes.
Yeah, his joke should have ended with his fucking hands in front of him and went like, oh. Fucking shithead, comptroller creep.
He's not a cop.
Whatever he is. Hope he slips in dog shit and fucking cracks his chin on the fucking steps.
Sorry, you're right, Jimmy.
What, his aunt?
His chin.
Yeah, you're not allowed to tell jokes.
It's a Chinese name.
Yeah, he's mentioning the Pope in a joke.
Yeah, if you get other people fired for telling jokes, you can't tell jokes.
Not at all.
Sorry, John Lowe.
Then I have another joke. What time John Lowe go to dentist? Tooth hurty. Tooth hurty. Get it?
I wonder if he knows any funny anecdotes about King Kong.
Well, Uncle Donks, let's be fair.
Once, did you hear the one about King Kong? He go to Hong Kong, play ping pong with the ding dong. True story.
Hey.
Love that music. Is this Coltrane?
I got to go one. You know what he should have done?
What?
Should have fucking pulled out his pecker and said, hey, you want some fucking egg roll stuff right here? Place would have went nuts.
What's the next joke?
I'll find out.
Well, first of all, this guy, he won a talking parrot. So he went to a pet shop. He went to the pet shop, and the owner of the pet shop, he was
in Africa.
He said, I want a talking parrot. And he said, well, I don't have a talking parrot, but I have this other bird that if you have patience, he will learn how to talk. So he sent him an owl.
This guy's so not
winning.
The guy
goes with the owl, he paid the money, $500.
He played the money.
And 2 weeks after, the pet shop owner saw him in the street. He said, well, is that bird talking already? And the guy said, you know, he's not talking yet, but I like the way he pays attention because every time I try to teach him a word, he goes.
What happened?
He opened his jacket.
What the fuck?
I didn't get it.
What language did he tell his joke in?
I don't know.
These people are incapable of
What's a pet shop?
A pet shop.
A pet shop.
Yeah. And then the bird come out. Oh, your bird was better?
And then the bird come out and stick his tongue out like a lizard to the girl.
And the bird comes out and I said, fly pelican.
I'm using a giant remote. I had to get the suds off the bottom of my arm so I make a over-the-top motion.
I say your womb is so polluted.
Yeah. I called Big Ernie from a payphone. They tell me I will not come back. I convey a soulless message.
Any more jokes?
Oh,
I like these.
I know a joke.
A young musician walks up to a wizened old New Yorker and says, excuse me, sir, how do you get to Carnegie Hall?
No.
And the old man says, practice, practice, practice.
And then the guy...
question had been, how do you get to City Hall? The answer would have been, forums, forums, forums.
You know how that joke should end? Shit. That joke should end with a fucking, an immediate flash fire. Like, what would be great is if nobody told him that there was gasoline all over the floors and ceiling. And when he finished that, someone threw a match in, and just the whoosh of the fire covering him.
And went, ta-da!
That was terrible.
Yeah.
What did he mean by that? That inside political fucking joke.
Forums.
Penthouse forum.
Yeah, forum.
What's that mean?
Exactly.
Why not five of them or something?
Exactly. I was going to say three of them, but you one up me. What the fudge?
My character's destroying the show.
Oh, I have a joke.
Oh, a joke? Oh, a joke.
Like an athlete.
Yes, Edgar.
How come the vegetables didn't want to be bothered on their honeymoon?
Why?
They said, let us alone.
What?
What? They're just as good as these fucking politicians' jokes.
Forums.
Forums. I like the whoosh of the fire,
like, you know,
sweeping over him.
If the floor was literally coated in gasoline and he had no idea, do you know how fast he'd be engulfed? Like if they had rubbed it with a paintbrush on the back of his jacket and his legs when he wasn't looking.
All right, next joke. We're almost done.
All right, so Erastus Corning was the mayor of Albany for maybe, I don't know, over 40 years. And he had to say best, a contentious relationship with the media, with the press. He didn't ever want to answer a question directly. So after their frustration of decades of not getting them to answer their question,
the delivery,
they stood around and they said, we can come up with a question that he has to answer. Oh,
the aristocrats.
We're smart enough. We can do this. And they said, all right. And they came up with the question. So at the next press conference, they said, Mayor, we have a question. What's your favorite color?
Oh.
And the mayor looked at them, smiled, and said, plaid.
At least the punchline was really good for that long setup.
I disagree.
Oh, see.
That was Grandpa.
Yeah,
of course he said plaid because the color of his socks, undershorts.
And Sam's.
Holy fuck. These are so bad.
Unbelievable.
There's not one guy that even had a...
I'm just mad now.
Yeah, now I'm angry again.
It's not it.
No, that's one more.
Right? How many more?
I actually have a problem with
my ears.
Erections.
What did he say?
Wait, what?
Anthony stepped all over this gentleman's punch.
Sorry, yeah, I did.
I actually have a problem with political jokes. Too often they get elected.
Ah, political jokes. Oh, that's a little.
You know what
jab.
Would help every one of these jokes at the end?
Yeah.
If it was like that fucking Quran chanting and then a far off explosion and then Allahu Akbar.
I love when they get all excited.
No, they couldn't be happier. Fucking gas truck going off at a fucking checkpoint. They go lollipops.
Oh, no, not this again.
Tootie hat.
I thought we were doing the Einstein thing instead.
Well, hold on now. I think there's some good acting.
Big boy finds a duty hat.
Who's the guy?
Look at young E.
Holy fuck, who's the guy holding the door?
Yeah, who's
Is
the guy?
You
with the, who's the guy with the Boris Karloff hairdo?
All right, we bring you back to a time.
Oh, wish it was a George Reeves shirt. See, he shot himself in the chest.
Iraq.
All right.
Now, this is the sequel video.
Oh.
Is this where I walk out? Yeah, it is. I really do a good job.
This is not Big Boy Makes a Duty. This is Big Boy Finds a Duty Hat.
Yeah, it was like Caddyshack 2, though.
But this is the one that ends with...
Okay.
Let's give it a ding.
All right, let's see.
This is the sequel.
2007.
Yeah, I'm tinkling.
Boris has
Wonderful. Hey, Greg.
Is the opening to the hat?
Oh, yeah, you went in there.
The top of the
opening. Oh, yeah. Don't keep the door open, you fucking sicko. I'm going to fill it.
That's right.
That was actually E-Rock's hat that had been stolen from his head and thrown in the toilet.
Thrown in the toilet.
And then Jim pissed on it and Opie shit in it.
Suddenly the hat felt like something smarter was inside of it.
I remember I really had to squeeze out a nugget.
Yeah.
Look at the shape of my nugget. Oh, you could tell there was some stress involved getting it out of my
nugget. It's the shit of someone that hasn't had water since the mid-80s. It was a colon cancer shit.
There's a lot of stress.
Yeah.
The birth of this nugget was not good.
Fucking threw it in there. What a little rotten. By the way, for artistic purposes, I'm going to go wipe somewhere else. Oh, God.
See the stress involved?
There's a little nugget in the hat.
And there's no toilet paper in the bowl because I wanted to make sure that it wouldn't cover up the dew. It's in a hat, though.
That is fucking
disgusting. Oh, boy! A duty hat!
Why did we do this?
Why wouldn't we is the question.
Yes.
Regular radio, by the way. Regular radio.
No, this is XM when we were kicked off, I think.
Yeah, we had to use their studio. They were redesigning ours.
Oh, redesigning, right.
How much did he get?
$2,400,000. Oh, nothing.
He drained all the water.
Come on.
His dumb shorts.
There's piss and shit on that hat.
Play the improv. I don't like the improv.
No, but you think. Oh.
Oh, God damn it.
Put the hat squarely on his head.
You didn't put the hat on. I'm not fucking accepting that.
Why?
You gotta put that hat on and pull the wind down.
Take two. Oh.
Jesus fucking Christ, that's disgusting.
It's a duty.
Oh, boy! A duty hat!
Who would say that ever?
Why would he say, oh boy, a duty hat?
There it is.
Who smushed it down?
I believe that was Nathaniel.
He's got a pillow on his head.
Holy shit. Oh, God. Let's go. Duty head. Duty head.
There's less in the hat. An intern.
Right?
This would get us arrested.
Well, we can't do that anymore.
I don't think we can. Imagine, let's run this past management. Can we have an intern take a hat full of one of our shit?
Yeah, as soon as you said intern, they would say
and
no.
And hat. Yes. No hats. What if there's an injury? Litigation.
Yeah, and can you believe he claims that that clip has cost him jobs?
Oh, he's just being silly. Insane.
Yeah, he should apply fucking Kohler.
Where are those videos? On Daily Motion?
Yeah, if you just
toilet head.
It's on our Facebook.
Facebook? Okay.
And if you just Google Opie Anthony Intern Jared,
right,
you'll find Big Boy finds a duty hat.
Okay.
Intern Jared becomes Cream Pie Jones.
Okay.
And Big Boy makes a nice duty.
Maybe maybe Jackie would want to, before she leaves, do a duty hat.
Well, yeah. I was thinking we'd make her a duty hat and then shave her eyebrows.
Right.
Oh, I thought you meant we would have her do one in a hat and then fight over who gets to take it home.
Okay. He's not
Epstein, stop playing with your testicles and look what I've done. This conveniently shaped vial contains an elixir which will increase the metabolism of anyone who drinks it. Can you imagine? This could eliminate the worldwide obesity epidemic permanently.
No, let me see.
No. Well, I suppose if you're careful, there's just the one and...
Say, this would fit perfectly. In mein heine?
No! No! No!
It's in! It's in mein heine!
Well, at least it's still intact. Now, give it back.
Here you go!
No! My elixir! It's all over the ceiling! Epstein, well, back to the drawing board, I suppose.
The Opie and Anthony Show.
There's a little person in the hallway.
What?
Who is that?
Who is it?
I don't know. Are they going into shade?
Exactly. Are they doing tricks?
Yeah. Who is that?
I don't know. They're going into shade. Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
A little person.
Who is it?
A dwarf.
We know all the dwarfs, though, don't we?
We did. Dwarves, stock, sneezy.
Probably some cereal promotions.
We know them all, don't we?
All the famous ones.
Yeah,
exactly.
We met the last one, Brad Williams.
The chick with the nice tits from Total Recall.
We know her, and we know the dude from Games of Thrones.
Oh. Peter Dinklage.
Would you... isn't that funny? He's got Dink in his name. It's like he's a dinky guy. It's
yeah.
Like
and Ledge, which in his name could be Peter Dink Curb.
And now there's a giant guy out there.
Oh, that's just.
Sad. Oh, my God. Jesus. Oh, what's his life partner?
Oh, that'd be great. It was a woman dwarf, though.
Yeah. Oh,
she's
shit.
Right here. Yeah. I don't know if. No, you can't see her.
So lean out. No, lean out and make circus sounds.
Her skirt. Her skirt ends where knees should be.
Oh. Holy shit, that guy's huge.
Yeah, he is,
who's he? Guy.
Wow. He's very tall.
Exactly.
Wow.
Holy fuck.
He was a ceiling fan installer. Like 6'8".
Would you
at
would
least
you
6'8".
Would you fuck a midget? Would you have sex with a midget?
Yeah, for the story.
Yeah. No, I don't know. I might get my dick Roland. Sucked.
Sorry.
Yeah, I might have fucked a midget.
What do you mean you
not might? Not really. But I might.
Would
I
you
might.
Get him a subscription to this program?
Let me say, you find a hot midget. Look at her, she's tatted up this one. Wow.
That's the porn star.
That's porn star midget?
We had her in, I think, right?
Bridget, right?
Yeah, Bridget the midget. Bridget the midget.
Yeah, we had her on. Or...
How many Bridget the midgets are there?
That'd
be a lot of them, right?
It's franchise yeah. like Gallagher.
It really is, yeah, yeah. Oh, only you could take a mallet and smash her. I'd love to smash a dwarf with a mallet.
Like a whack-a-mole.
Oh. I just sat on the toilet upstairs and nothing happened.
Uh-oh.
I felt a gurgly in my stomach and I traipsed upstairs like fucking, oh, it was going to be a shit fucking party.
Wow.
Nothing happened?
No.
Shit, it's too bad.
Yeah, it was like there's spackle in my colon.
Where's Roland?
Roly.
For Shark Week.
Find out who all these people are. Look at her.
Aw.
She's like tiny. And then who's this guy with the tats?
I don't know.
Wow, that huge guy is protecting her. Who is she? Go find out, Sam. Come on.
Yeah, Sam, you know.
Yeah, go out there and yell, hey, thing.
Open the door. Open the doll.
Hey, fidget.
Aw.
I thought you were going to do like a hey, Tucci, like hey, midget.
Oh. Can't yell midget.
Yeah. You can't yell midget. People that's get, like the faggot word.
You'll be fucking, you'll be, you know, out the door.
Yeah, exactly. Can't do that anymore.
Is it the M word? Yeah.
Yeah. You can't do that. They'll boot you right through the dog door.
We got Tara Reid talking about sharks for Shark Week.
Enough of Sharknado. We all had a good laugh. It was goofy. But people are taking this thing like it's, you know, oh, the sequel. Will Tara Reid be in? No one's going to give a shit.
They put it in movie theaters and it's doing really well.
No, it isn't, is
it? Yes.
Oh, God.
They put it on TV a couple of times and more people were watching it from the prior viewing. Oh, and then they threw it in a movie theater and people are going to see it.
Sharknado.
It's ironic. Hey, let's go see Sharknado with some popcorn.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
Hipsters. Crazy.
But they've had a lot of movies like that. Why was it this one that hit?
It's just the way it works sometimes. Yeah.
A lot of promotion, too.
Here's Tara Reid.
Today, I was like, all right, I don't want to, like, really sound stupid when I do this show today. Like, so learn a little education on sharks. So I look up sharks on the internet, and then I see, like, whale sharks. I'm like, oh, that must mean a whale and a shark have sex. And then I think, well, how does a whale and a shark have sex? And then I looked
up. Was there a video of it?
No, because there's a thing called whale sharks. Yes. So I thought they must, you know. And then I realized that whales were mammals. And sharks are animals. They have nothing to do with each other.
Animals. You ever see a tiger shark?
So basically, the dolphins have sex with each other, but the sharks don't. So I thought, then how is it such a thing? But the difference is there's a whale shark, because he's the biggest shark in the ocean, but he's not so scary. And then you got the great white. It's all, there's like over 400 kinds of sharks. But the whale shark is kind of interesting. He's not so mean.
I know exactly what
you're
talking about.
So much information here.
This is what you would have to listen to in between blowjobs.
Wow.
Oh, my God. Shut that, up.
Did Carson Daly have to listen to that?
Yes. Of course
imagine
he did.
Imagine that.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, whale shark. It was like it's a shark that had sex with a whale. And then the whale took its condom full of jism home with him. So you get it.
Nagel seed.
The Nagel seed. Yeah.
Very valuable.
Who was it, Sam?
Wow, is she an idiot?
Oh, yeah.
The intern said it was Marley Marl.
Who?
DJ Marley Marl?
Yeah.
Which guy? With the tattoos?
Yeah, they said they were all there. It was all Marley Marl's.
Who's the midget?
Marley Marl's a legend.
Yeah, I know.
Fuck, I wish I would have known. I would have got a picture with fucking Marley Marl.
Around?
Is he?
The intern said they were all his entourage.
Where's Marley Marl?
Oh, he
was that tattoo guy?
It's like a circus thing.
I don't know.
Wait, was he the tattoo guy?
Walking around with a circus.
I don't know if there's any new pictures of him. I can't.
Yeah, Marley Marl.
I mean, he never had tattoos before.
Mm, that's cool.
Fuck.
An older gentleman.
You would have liked a picture with him?
Yeah, he put out a rap. Big Daddy Kane. He did a rap with a bunch of guys. It was like five. I forget what it was called. There was like five guys. It was like a mass race and a few. He had a whole record, and him and DJ Red Alert used to fucking. Have a? Or is he really?
Roland's saying he's still in the lobby.
Was it about the club?
No. Well, yeah, kind of.
Yeah. No. Yeah.
Yeah, kind of.
I want to take a photo of him.
He's in the lobby. If you want to run down there,
I don't
Jimmy.
Know which one he is?
I help you.
Roland will go with you.
No, he'll mess
Roland
me up.
Be like, yeah, there he is. That one.
Oh, it's Tomasco. He won't. Roland won't. No, you won't.
There's a picture.
Yeah, that guy.
That's not the big guy, is it?
No.
He's not that big.
No, he just has like an entourage of like freaks walking around with him, it looks like.
I love this.
Really tall guy, really short girl.
Uh-oh,
woman,
who's going to work
whatever.
The camera?
Don't
Sam
fuck
Roberts?
It up. Don't fuck
Sam,
it up.
You know what it's like.
Sam, take the picture of the DJ, Sam.
You
His
know
name
it.
Is Marley Marl. The same name twice.
Uh-oh, Sam, don't fuck this up. Don't you fuck this up. Man, Jimmy loves pictures.
He sure does.
What is he going to do with that, you think?
That's a dumb one.
Like after, yeah, that's kind
of
like.
Like we have a lot of people come in here, and I always go, yeah, that would be a dumb one. So I don't get it done.
Yeah, and then you don't take the picture because.
And
like,
then I'm like, oh no, that's not a dumb one. I gotta get that picture.
I know what he'll do with it.
What?
I know what he'll do with it.
What?
He's been here for other old school rappers and got all their photos. So he'll make a nice little, maybe not collage, but a little presentation of old school rap.
Oh, he's coming back.
Oh boy, it didn't work out. What happened?
He left already.
Did you throw out any racial epithets when you found out he was gone?
No, I thought he was here.
Oh.
That's how you show love. Jesus.
Yeah, I don't care who's first and who's last.
Like, I got pictures of a lot of celebrities, like, from in here, you know?
Right.
But I don't know. I wouldn't even know what to do with them.
My great regret is not coming back for James Gandolfini, even though I was home working on Red Eye material.
Get him next time he comes in.
He's dead.
Oh.
It's a great regret.
Did they steal his Rolex when he was dead or something?
Someone stole my Rolex.
What?
Very difficult situation.
Yeah?
What happened? Rolex theft, victim, and death?
Oh, man.
Who took his Rolex?
Fucking piece of shit.
What happened, Sam?
They're saying somebody stole his Rolex within hours after he died.
From where? Not off his body.
Probably, I think, the hotel.
Oh, okay.
Based on an insurance form filed by James's people. Someone stole a $3,000 Rolex.
It's a cheap Rolex.
From James's hotel room the day he died.
It's my Submariner.
I had a Rolex stolen at my wedding.
Oh, damn.
Yep.
Wow, man. That's brutal. Sometimes you think, like, oh, that sucks. He's fucking dead.
You can't have Rolexes just laying around.
No.
I know who stole it. So.
Really?
Yeah, I have no idea.
E-Rock.
No doubt.
Holy
if
shit,
you have something
really?
To say.
You know who stole the fucking Rolex?
Yeah, give it back.
Give it back. All right. You got me.
No, my lovely wife brought two Rolexes to the hotel where we got married, and one of them got stolen. She wasn't sure which one she wanted to give me for a little wedding gift.
Maid?
Huh?
I think it was one of the maids. Is it Lupe?
I think it was someone that I'd never heard from after the wedding, to be honest with
you. Oh, shit.
Who?
Yeah, I don't.
A little guilt?
Can't just say it.
Who? Oh, you don't want to say it on the air.
I can't.
Yeah. She can. He could publicly accuse
someone
of thievery.
This person I never heard from
again
after the wedding.
Oh, man.
That's scandal.
Never heard from her again after the wedding.
Shit.
And there's a Rolex missing.
You haven't heard from her since?
Nope. Not a once.
She might have given it to her boyfriend.
Not a once.
Well, put it in her cunt.
Wow, that's something.
But someone stole it. Got married at the Ritz-Carlton in Philly. They swear none of their people took it.
No cameras?
It was a room we were using that people were coming and going.
Uh-huh.
That person had access to it?
Yeah. A lot of people had access.
Are there any other clues besides the fact that she...
It's gone.
Yeah, that it's gone and you haven't heard from her.
I want a Colonel Mustard's mustache hairs was in the room.
Well, why wouldn't I hear from this person again?
Yes.
Well, she begged to be invited to the wedding. And then I never hear from her again. Huh. And there's a Rolex missing. Those are the two clues.
Well.
But what happened with Gandolfini? They didn't take it off his body.
No, they didn't take
it
off.
So it was in the hotel room.
Yeah.
That's why I bring up my situation, because it was a hotel.
Yes.
I think it was a hotel room officially that a bunch of people had access to. So obviously a maid or somebody took the Rolex, right?
I think so.
Either that or they're pulling some shenanigans.
Like with the insurance forms?
Yeah, trying to get as much money as they can because the government's taking fucking millions of James Gandolfini's fucking money that he worked for.
Yeah,
he didn't have death tax.
He didn't have his will set up properly.
Well,
it was told to me.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
You could protect from that.
Yeah, he had an incomplete will.
My will is incomplete.
He was going to get to it.
I was going to get to it.
But that's what everyone does. I'll get to it.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
you're going to get to it. Damn! Wow. Oop. Well, poor fuck. He doesn't care now.
I mean, cigars and scotch is online. Cigars and scotch. Both of you guys there?
Yeah. Yep. Opie, this person that took your Rolex, did you even like him?
Did I like the person?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, so I was going to say, you got them out of your life for the cost of a Rolex. You got off life.
You go to weddings, John? Louis Beans.
Very good, buddy. CNS on the phone. It's been a while. I think we did all our material. Al Roker overslept. Yeah. Who gives a fuck?
Yeah, that was a story.
Got a queen queen's mom pimping out her 11-year-old daughter.
All right,
fucking pig.
Damn.
He said it was the first time in 39 years or something like that that Al Roker had overslept.
Yeah, that's pretty impressive.
Yep.
Typical.
Did he make it into work today?
He did. Today he made it.
It would be funny if he overslept now every day for the next 6 months.
Get on the old Nagel timing system.
Ah, yeah.
Then we just got an asshole out there.
Oh,
he's in the booth.
Listen to this asshole.
He's
been struck by lightning. He's been bitten by a snake. He's been attacked by monkeys.
Oh.
And now, now he was bitten by a shark.
This guy.
All a... one guy.
What's this guy's book called? Luck of the Irish?
Oh. All right, no.
Oh. Naya plugs you, Rocky. You can't do it.
He survived a lightning strike, a rattlesnake bite, two separate monkey attacks, and now he's recovering in a Tampa hospital after he was bitten by a shark in the Bahamas.
I'll tell you
fuck.
Why that's not impressive.
Why?
He's the manager of a shark monkey snake store.
That would be the worst store ever.
Oh, God.
For all your shark monkey snake needs.
Yes.
Damn. See that other fucking story, though, with that the two kids that got...
Oh, my God, the fucking python?
The python?
Oh, yeah, that's horrible.
They were living over a pet store. And it got out. The thing goes into the room and chokes out the kids. Fuck. That's like monster movie shit.
It's heartbreaking. And you see the picture of them on the paper, cover of the paper. They're wearing little cute, like... cartoon Angry Birds jam. It's fucking...
Maybe that's what happened. The snake was like, oh, fucking birds.
I don't think this... Yeah, maybe.
I don't know. It choked him, though.
I'd just be interested to hear how people spin it where God had this in his design.
Well, I'm sure. You know.
That's...
He works in mysterious ways.
Live a good life, and good things happen.
We must look at what the Lord does on a daily basis.
Two brothers just squeezed it down. How fucking horrible.
That's one primitive-ass way to go.
No kidding.
That's fucking... There are people, fucking cavemen, that went the same
right.
way.
Right. That's just unbelievable.
Terrible when you're top of the food chain and, you know, someone skips a couple of brackets and nails you. Fuck.
All right, we're going to get out of here. Let's not forget about the Opie and Anthony podcast. Episode number 13 is out there. Please go get it. I think the link is on our Facebook page, Opie and Anthony on
it's
Facebook.
It's there right next to Duty Hat.
Right next to Duty Hat. So you got to go to our Facebook page today, which we barely promote. Opie and Anthony on Facebook. And there'll be a link to the podcast, episode number 13. We got a couple interviews with the Breaking Bad guys, Dean Norris and Betsy Brent. They were terrific on our show.
Yeah.
Suck Cock for K-Rock is on the latest podcast. And Master Poe's Hurricane Evacuation Plan, which was very, very funny. And then, of course, the Opie and Anthony Nugget, which Sam gave away earlier. But if you didn't hear that, it'll be a nice little surprise for you at the end of the podcast.
And stay tuned plugs. For Jimmy Norton's
advice show. Wednesday.
Which is the show that comes on after our show that doesn't get people in trouble.
Absolutely not. It's just me giving...
Helps people.
Me just saving lives.
Right.
Helping people, not hurting people.
Absolutely. Not hurting people.
That's
right.
Tonight at 8 o'clock, I will be on Current TV on John Fugelsang's show. And Dick Cavett, I'll be on with Dick Cavett.
Oh, wow, that's cool.
And also at 11 p.m. again tonight, the Insane Clown Posse Theater on Fuse. So whatever your local channel for Fuse is, I will be on both shows tonight. And then JimNorton.com is almost ready to go up. There's not much on it yet because I don't have that many tour dates coming up. And it's just a few links to videos. I mean, I don't know what to put on the
anal
site.
Anal gaping?
Pictures. Well, yeah. Pictures, there's a million pictures of me, though. I'm going to start putting
whatever. It's a work in progress. It's going to be great. JimNorton.com.
Well, right now, it's nothing.
And we're thinking about getting OpieAnthony.com up and running again.
Oh, cool.
Finally. Thinking about it. We're in the thinking about it stage.
2013, you know.
Right, you know. We just suck.
Why not?
We should have a t-shirt out there. We should have a website out there.
We are terrible.
But we're thinking about it, so that's good. Yeah. That's good news.
Mulling it over.
We're mulling it over. We're in the mulling it over stage.
Mulling it.
Is that it, Jimmy?
Yeah.
And the advice show is next, so stay right here.